Now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please turn your attention to the area in front of the pitcher's mound here at Bethpage Ballpark on this Saturday evening, a summertime Saturday. It's my pleasure and privilege to introduce to you tonight's Long Island Ducks on-field host, a man who enjoys every 4th of July weekend. Here's Jason Lenny.
Thank you, Bullet Bob O'Tom. Good evening, Bethpage Ballpark. Tonight, I'm joined by Everbank Client Solutions representative, Jerome Momaski, who will be throwing out our first pitch to Long Island Ducks, Bud Harrelson. Take it away, Jerome. Everybody give Jerome a big round of applause.
Advance before the game begins, stop by the New York Life Concourse table. Down the main concourse behind home plate, bring your boy and girl with you and have them sign up for the Child ID program brought to you by our good friends from New York Life. Each family participating in the program tonight will be entered to win an official Long Island Ducks autographed baseball from Long Island Ducks second baseman Josh Barfield. Remember that the raffle that's going on at the New York Life Concourse table, main concourse behind home plate. Sign up for that raffle this evening. May be winning an autographed Long Island Ducks baseball from second baseman Josh Barfield. Summer Baseball Clinic, the first one for the year for the month of July, is coming up fast in just 2 weeks. On Friday and Saturday, July the 19th and 20th, that's a Friday and Saturday. It is a two-day session. What could be better than learning great skills from your favorite Long Island Duck players or coaches right here on the field in front of you this evening? Participants receive an official clinic jersey and equipment bag. If you need more information or if you'd like to register your boy or girl, visit the Sports Authority ticket kiosk. All the main concourse behind home plate, or check it out at liducks.com. That's liducks.com for the Long Island Ducks Summer Baseball Clinic. There's one in July and there's one in August. The first one in July is coming up on July 19th and 20th, a two-day session. It's a Friday and Saturday. The one in August is on August 16th and 17th. Hey, thanks. Don't forget about our 50-50 raffle tonight. You can pick up your 50-50 raffle tickets. Pittsburgh Blues manager Willie Upshaw and the manager of the 2012 Atlantic League champion Alabama Bucks, Kevin Baye. And now fans, it's time to get out your Alabama Bucks scorecards, your pens, and your pencils, because here's tonight's National Grid starting lineups.
Welcome inside Bethpage Ballpark for Long Island Ducks baseball on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN. The Ducks and Bluefish playing game two of their three-game weekend set. The Ducks coming off a 3-2 victory yesterday, keyed by Bill Hall's two-run home run and a strong pitching by Bob Zimmerman and the bullpen to give the Ducks a win in the first game of the series and a leg up. Second half of the season continues. Hey there, everybody. I'm Tom Felice, bringing you all the action live from behind home plate here at Bethpage Ballpark for game number 75 of the Long Island Ducks season and game number 5 of the second half of the season. The Ducks and Bluefish both 3-1 so far in the second half, atop the Liberty Division. Mentioned that last night's starter was Bob Zimmerman. He went 5 innings, gave up just 2 hits and 1 run. A solo home run to the man who led off the ball game, Daniel Mayorga. And Zimmerman cruised from there, giving up just 1 hit the rest of the way as he stepped right back into the rotation, just like he was last year for the Ducks when he started 27 games. Zimmerman had a very good start. Before the game, I had a chance to talk to Bob Zimmerman about his start yesterday and what he was doing in the offseason. Very interesting stuff from Bob Zimmerman, and you will hear that next as the North Shore LIJ Southside Hospital pregame show continues here on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN.
Head plate first base, number 22, Joe Ash Rodine, number 22. Batting second, at second base, number 28. Josh Barfield, number 28. Hitting third for Long Island and playing third base, number 21. Bryant Nelson, number 21. Batting in the cleanup position in left field, number 6. Bill Hall, number 6. Hitting fifth for your Long Island Ducks and playing right field, number 13. Adam Bailey, number 13. Batting sixth for Long Island, designated hitter, number 16, Ray Navarrete, number 16. Hitting seventh for Long Island, behind the plate, catcher, number 30, Ralph Enriquez, number 30. Batting in the eighth position and playing center field, number 24, Craig Finnick. And hitting in the ninth position for your Long Island Ducks at shortstop, number 12, Dan Lyons, number 12. And pitching tonight for your Long Island Ducks and warming up with the Ducks bullpen at the end of the right field line is left-hander, number 35, the D-Train, Dontrell Willis, number 35. The Long Island Ducks are managed by Kevin Baez, pitching coach Steve Fulkel, and the bench coach is Buddy Harrelson. And that is tonight's National Grid starting lineup. National Grid, here with you and here for you.
Welcome back to the North Shore LIJ Southside Hospital pregame show, joined by last night's starting and winning pitcher for the Ducks, Bob Zimmerman. Bob, how's it going?
Going well.
Bob, you made your first start of the season yesterday. How are you feeling physically after your outing?
A little tired. A lot of pitches. I've been going one inning, two innings at a time. So the extra workload, it was good to get out there and do it, but got to work into it.
What is the transition like for you? You know, different parts of your career, you've been a starter and a reliever.
When they tell me to pitch, I pitch. Just as long as I got the ball and get to go out there, I'm happy and happen to do well, and we won the game.
How does your mindset change when you are starting versus relieving?
Really not much to it. I think when I start, I try to control the pace a little bit more. Just get the game flowing, try to get a quick pace going. As far as relieving, I feel like I take more time working on the mound.
Is there one that you prefer over the other?
No, they're really both fine as long as I'm out there.
How much does it help having a catcher like Ramon Castro with so much experience behind the plate?
Oh, it's huge. I mean, having a guy back there that you trust and takes the thinking out of it. I don't have to do any thinking. I just do what he says.
In this past off season, you were the pitching coach for College Maryville University. What was that experience like?
It gave me a different outlook on playing, for sure, and makes me appreciate my coaches I've had and do have a lot more, and the jobs that they do. But it also gives you a different perspective on the game and makes you understand why things happen and why coaches do certain things, make certain decisions.
Is there anything that you've been able to take from your time coaching and use it for yourself now that you're back playing with the Ducks?
I mean, I think the biggest thing as far as with those guys is just keep pounding on them to just throw strikes. First pitch strike, throw strike, strike percentage, just filling the zone up because walks will kill you. And so, I mean, I've always had a problem in my career with walks, so I'm trying to just fill the zone up, fill it up.
What was the transition like for you becoming a coach? How did the situation develop, and then how did you feel as you started?
I had a buddy that I worked with doing camps and lessons and that kind of work in the off season, who just got the head coaching job there. And he actually last year just called me near the end of the season and wanted me to come on, and I said, okay, as soon as I'm done here, I'll help out.
Are you looking for that to be your future in baseball?
You know, it's good to get my foot in the door, and I did enjoy it and could definitely see myself doing that for a career.
What did you enjoy most about coaching those kids?
Man, I think just being around the youth and enjoying their experience, basically. Trying to help them as much as I can and give them the best opportunity to succeed. And when they succeed, just your excitement for them is really enjoyable.
You've been in pro ball now for 10 years. What was it like going back to college? Was it like you remembered?
Yeah, it was a lot more energy as far as like rah-rah and I guess cheering, if you want to say, but a lot of energy, and I enjoyed it. I brought some youthfulness out in me.
All right, Bob, thanks a lot. Best of luck going forward this year with the Ducks.
Thank you.
That was Bob Zimmerman, last night's starting and winning pitcher for Long Island, and the North Shore LIJ Southside Hospital pregame show continues after this.
Last but not least, playing for all of our Long Island Duck fans tonight. Here he comes down the left field line, the New York area's number one sports mascot. They got number double look, and here comes the Long Island Ducks, Quacker Jack. Quacker Jack is sponsored by MSC Industrial Supply and is the president of the Webpage Long Island Ducks Kids Club. Boys and girls, sign up tonight for the Kids Club at the Sports Authority Picket Kiosk, located on the land concourse right behind home plate.
Dontrell Willis taking his warm-up throws for the Long Island Ducks as he prepares to face the Bridgeport Bluefish here at Bethpage Ballpark. I'm Tom Felice. It's time for the starting lineups between the Bluefish and the Ducks. Daniel Mayora leads off for Bridgeport. He plays second base. He's followed by Austin Crum, the left fielder, batting second. Both of them named the Atlantic League All-Star team, the All-Star game on Wednesday down in Southern Maryland. Prentice Redmond bats third and plays right field. He's followed by the designated hitter, Alexis Gomez. Then it's Louis Lopez, the third baseman, batting fifth. James Simmons, the center fielder, bats sixth. Louis Rodriguez, the machete, former Duck, catches and bats seventh. Victor Diaz, the first baseman, bats eighth. And Iggy Suarez, the shortstop, is in the ninth slot for Willie Upshaw's Bridgeport Bluefish. For the Ducks, Joe Ashbrodeen leads off and plays first field, the second baseman. Then it's Bryant Nelson down at third. Bill Hall bats fourth and plays in left field. Adam Bailey, the right fielder, bats fifth. Ray Navarette, the DH, bats sixth. Ralph Enriquez catches in bats seventh. Center fielder Craig Binnick bats eighth, but Dan Lyons, the shortstop, batting ninth for Long Island. Mike Parisi, the starter for Bridgeport, and Dontrell Willis, the lefty on the mound for the Ducks, just about ready to throw the first pitch of this ball game. Daniel Mayora steps in from the right side. Willis, pitching with his traditional orange glove, kicks and fires. First pitch is low for ball one. First pitch at 7:06. Willis winds, kicks in, deals 1-0. Swung on, hit on the ground, sharply to second base. Barfield waits for it. Fields whips it over to first. And the first man of the game, Daniel Mayora, is retired. 88 degrees at first pitch. A little sticky in Central Islip today, but everybody out there ready to go. Both teams taking batting practice, getting an early sweat in. Shadows covering the pitcher's mound, home plate, and the first base bag, and pretty much nothing else at this moment. Lights are turned on. Austin Crum stands in from the left side. First pitch. Willis hits the outside corner with strike one. Crum, a 325 hitter, tied with Mayora for best on the team and sixth in the Atlantic League. One strike pitch. Check swing. Breaking ball misses low and away. And the count goes to 1-1. The umpires for this game, Alan Reyes behind the plate, Matt Hensel down at first, and Hank Himinen, the third base umpire. Willis takes a deep breath on the mound, nods in agreement with catcher Ralph Enriquez, the 1-1. Swung on and missed. Another good breaking ball from Dontrell. And the count goes to 1-2. Crum with two home runs, 27 driven in. Leads the team with three triples. One of two lefties in the lineup against the lefty Dontrell Willis. Crum and the cleanup hitter Alexis Gomez, the two lefty swingers. Crum out of the batter's box. Now he's set to go. Slightly open stance. The 1-2 on the way. Way outside with that breaking ball. Skips all the way to the backstop. Lands in the Ducks' script logo. Painted behind home plate. That boy over to pick it up. Count evens a 2-2 to Austin Crum. No score, one away. Top of the first. The kick and the 2-2. Swung on, popped up. Foul territory, left side. Catcher Enriquez discards the mask. Seeds to the third baseman, Bryant Nelson, who makes the play, jogging down the line. He ended up about 15 feet off the line and probably 30 feet from home plate as he recorded the out. And that's the second out of the top of the first. No score. Here's Prentice Redman, the right-handed hitting right fielder. He's on a five-game hitting streak, averaged a .248. Two homers, 33 driven in. Kick in the first pitch. Change up on the outside corner for strike one. A lot of off-speed stuff so far for Dontrell Willis. Seems to be pitching backwards a little bit. One strike pitch. That misses low, and the count evens at 1-1. Bryant Nelson plays third base. Dan Lyons at shortstop for Long Island. 1-1. Fastball just misses inside to the righty. Josh Barfield at second. Joash Brodeen at first. Bill Hall, Craig Binnick, Adam Bailey left to right in the outfield. 2-1 delivery. Breaking ball on the outside corner. That evens the count at 2-2. Another sharp curve from Dontrell Willis. Willis taking more time than normal between pitches. Ready now. He winds, kicks, and deals 2-2. Fastball just misses low. A full count to Prentice Redman. Two outs, no score here in the first inning. Swing and a foul. 3-2 pitch hit into the stands on the right side. So they'll do it all again at 3-2. Here to Prentice Redman. Dontrell setting at the belt. He winds and fires 3-2. Swung on, hit weakly up the first base line. Brodeen, the first baseman, fields, flips to Willis, the pitcher covering. And he makes the out. to retire the side. Willis cut in front of the runner Redmond a little bit, and when he did, he stuck out his glove as if to say, sorry to make this so close. But Dontrell did what he had to do and recorded the out to retire the Bluefish 1-2-3 here in the top of the first, heading to the bottom of the first. Time for the Ducks offense to come to the plate. And you'll hear it here on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN.
The O-Fans National Grid has sponsored this year's Long Island Ducks street team, so make sure you look out for your hometown team all year long. Our National Grid is proud to support the Long Island Ducks and communities around Long Island, and is committed to the energy needs of Long Islanders today and in the future. The street team powered by National Grid will be in a location near you soon, so make sure you check out liducks.com for a complete schedule. Hey, boys and girls, check it out. At the end of the third base concourse, way, way down at the end, you'll see that big orange and green bubble bouncing all over the place with Cracker Jack's head on the top. That's the Long Island Ducks bounce house. It's one of the big attractions here at Duck Page Ballpark, so make sure you try it out tonight. Take your family and friends down to the end of the third base concourse and enjoy yourself in the Long Island Ducks bounce house. Have a good time while you're here at our ballpark.
Bottom of the first inning, no score between the Long Island Ducks and the Bridgeport Bluefish. Mike Parisi on the mound for Bridgeport. He's had a rough go of it this season. A record of 2-10, a 5.73 earned run average. This is his 15th start. He has given up 101 hits in 80 innings. Joe Ash Brodeen leads off. He'll be followed by Josh Barfield and Bryant Nelson here in the first for Long Island. Brodeen hitting .331, tops on the team, third in the league. He will be going to the All-Star game next week down in Waldorf, Maryland. Switch hitter bats on the left side, righty Parisi fires. First pitch, fastball on the outside corner for strike one. Brodeen, 8 home runs, 32 driven in, leads the team with 17 doubles. One strike offering, another fastball on the outside corner, strike two. Brodeen leads the team with 27 walks, second in the league with 92 hits to Daniel Mayora of the Bluefish. 0-2 high and tight. Brodeen avoids it, count to 1-2. Parisi ready to go. Brodeen out of the box. Now he steps back in, slightly open stance. White batting gloves, holding a natural colored bat. 1-2. Skipped in there. Count evens up at 2-2. The Ducks and Municipal Credit Union have teamed up this season to present the Walk with a Purpose promotion. Every time a Long Island Ducks player walks, Municipal Credit Union will make a donation to the Quackerjack Foundation. Municipal Credit Union, serving members since 1916. 2-2, curveball just misses outside. Parisi taking an extra beat as he walks back up the slope of the mound. Now he'll have to throw a payoff pitch to Joe Ash Brodeen, leading off the bottom of the first, no score. Here it is. Misses inside. That's ball four. Brodeen draws his 28th walk of the season. Another Municipal Credit Union walk with a purpose. Every time a Ducks batter walks, the Quackerjack Foundation wins. And that is the first walk of the series. No walks issued at all in the game yesterday. 17 strikeouts combined. No walks as the Ducks beat the Bluefish 3-2 in the series opener last night. Here's the second baseman, Josh Barfield. Bats from the right side, hitting .297. Three homers, 15 driven in. Takes first pitch fastball high and inside for ball one. The defense behind Parisi. Luis Lopez down at third base. Iggy Suarez at shortstop. Daniel Mayora man second base with Victor Diaz at first. He holds on Joe as Parisi pitches from the stretch for the first time. The set at the belt, the one ball pitch. That is high. And now it's a 2-0 count. Austin Crum, James Simmons, Prentice Redman, left to right in the outfield. Luis Rodriguez catches as Parisi throws over to first base, and Brodin gets back standing up. Fastball way inside. Barfield jackknifes out of the way, and that catcher Rodriguez has to stick his arm all the way out to avoid a wild pitch. No walks yesterday, a walk, and now a 3-0 count to Josh Barfield here in the bottom of the first. Scoreless ball game, Ducks and Bluefish. 3-0. Curveball on the inside corner for a strike. Barfield thought it missed inside. He had started his walk towards first, almost throwing the bat away. Parisi from the stretch, throw to first. Brodin back in, standing up, a high throw. Victor Diaz grabbed it right around the head of Joash Brodin. Matt Way, pitcher on the inactive list, coaches first base for the Ducks. Manager Kevin Baez down at third. Check swing grounder to first. Diaz field throws to second for a one, and Suarez, the shortstop, does not make a relay throw as Barfield beats it out. Brodin retired on the fielder's choice. The out goes 3-6. Now there's a man on with a man out for the Ducks in the bottom of the first, with Bryant Nelson stepping in. Nelson hitting .266, leads the active members of the Ducks with 10 homers and 37 runs batted in. No score in this one here in the bottom of the first inning. Nelson, a switch hitter, bats from the left side. All 10 of his home runs have come when swinging from the left side of the plate. First pitch, righty Parisi fires the fastball on the inside corner. That is strike one. Barfield, 3 of 4 in stolen base attempts on the season. The Ducks, not much of a running team. 7 out of 8 teams in the Atlantic League, 0-1. Just misses outside, the count evens up. Ducks with 27 stolen bases on the season. They only have more stolen bases than the York Revolution, who have just 22. 1-1 count to Bryant Nelson, throw to first base. Barfield back in on two steps. Parisi from the stretch, the set, the 1-1. On the outside corner, that's strike two. No score, bottom of the first. Bryant Nelson at the plate. Nelson now out of the batter's box. Takes a deep breath and steps back in. Barfield to the edge of the cutout with his lead. 1-2. Swung on, poked through the left side hole, and down for a base hit. Crum picks it up and throws it back in. Barfield up to second base on Bryant Nelson's single, the first hit of the ball game, and the Ducks have two on with one out here in the bottom of the first of a scoreless ball game. And stepping up is the man you want coming up with men on base. It's Bill Hall. Hall with 3 home runs in the past 2 games. A 2-run homer last night, and 2 home runs on July 4th, including the 3-run go-ahead homer to give the Ducks the 7-5 victory 2 days ago. All in left field tonight. A right-handed bat, wide open stance. First pitch, breaking ball in there for a strike. Second baseman Daniel Mayora shaded pretty close to the bag. Big gap on the right side of the infield for Hall, should he choose to try to sneak one through the infield. Outfield straight up. Left fielder Crum might be a step deep. One strike pitch. Fastball on the outside corner, strike two. A great pitch from Parisi. Just hitting the outside corner. And Bill Hall is quickly in an 0-2 hole. No score. Bottom of the first inning. Ducks on first base and second base. Hall taps home plate with a black bat. Just the batting helmet with his right hand as Parisi steps off. Parisi stepping off again, and that's going to cause Hall to step out of the batter's box. Some cat and mouse here between Mike Parisi, the pitcher for Bridgeport, and Bill Hall, the Ducks batter. Lopez, the third baseman, guarding the line. Two-strike pitch. Curveball just misses high. Count to 1-2. Parisi looked like he expected that to be a called strike. Didn't miss by much with that breaking ball. Hall hitting .274, 7 homers, 24 driven in his time with the Ducks here in 2013. 1-2. Swung on, fought off, foul on the right side. Count remains 1-2. Next pitch being number 20 for Mike Parisi here in the first inning. He has recorded just one out. There is no score, but the Ducks threatening with men on first and second. Hall digging the right foot into the back of the batter's box. Set at the belt, the 1-2. Swung on, hit on a line left field. Crum over, he reaches up and he drops it. Barfield has to stop at third base. Everybody up one station. Now a throw home is a bit wild. Cut off by Parisi. And the Ducks have the bases loaded. One out here in the bottom of the first. Looked like Crum had a bead on that one. He stuck up the glove, and it hit in the glove and bounced out. It's ruled a hit for Hall, so that's a single to left field. Nelson to second, and Barfield to third. Adam Bailey stepping up, the right fielder, hitting .260, 9 homers, 30 driven in. Chance to drive in a few here. The base is loaded for Long Island. Bailey 1-for-6 this season with the bases loaded. Takes first pitch, curveball low, 4-1. Third baseman Lopez, even with the bag, middle of the infield, that double play depth. First baseman Diaz behind the runner Hall. 1-0. Swung on, hit on the ground, sharply through the legs of Diaz at first. It kicks into foul territory. Barfield scores. Nelson with a big turnaround third, but he does not go home, and the Ducks strike first as Adam Bailey smashed that ball to Diaz, and he was charged with an error as he could not make the play.
Batting in the sixth position will be along on the Ducks, fifth designated hitter, number 16, Ray Navarrete.
Base is still loaded for Long Island as the Ducks take a 1-0 lead and still just one out here in the bottom of the first. Ray Navarrete stepping in from the right side, but not before there's a mound visit by Pat Ahern, the pitching coach, is going to talk to Parisi. Parisi has had his struggles. He had a string of 10 consecutive losses between May 5th and June 24th. In that stretch, he received just 24 runs in support in those 10 games. But he also had his issues as well.
Gave up
10 hits in one of those outings. Gave up 9 hits 4 times throughout that stretch. He's given up 2 hits so far, just 1 run, but the 1 error keeps this inning going. Bases loaded for the Ducks, a run already in, and Ray Navarrete stepping in from the right side. Navarrete tamps down the dirt with his right foot as he steps up. Parisi still from the stretch. Swing and a high fly ball, deep left center. Simmons, the center fielder, into the gap, reaches up to make the catch. Nelson tags. He scores on a jog. Sacrifice fly for Ray Navarrete. 18th run batted in this season. And the Ducks take a 2-0 lead. That's the second out of the inning. But the Ducks are happy that they have scored another run and taken a 2-0 lead here in the bottom of the first. Sends up Ralph Enriquez, the catcher. Switch hitter swings from the left side. Now it's Bill Hall on second, Adam Bailey on first, as Enriquez takes a curveball on the inside corner for strike one. Enriquez hitting 204, four homers, 15 driven in, 0-1. Another breaking ball. This one misses low, and the count evens up. Enriquez last played on Wednesday, went 0-for-3 with a walk. A check of second base, the 1-1. Breaking ball on the inside corner again. The count to 1-2. Enriquez with a black sleeve covering his left arm. Right arm bare, 1-2. Fastball high and away. Count evens at 2-2. And the pitch. Curveball just missing outside. A full count to Ralph Enriquez. Runners can get a head start. Hall from second and Bailey from first. Ducks with two in already to take a 2-0 lead here in the first inning. A set. 3-2 runners go. Swung on, fouled off in the batter's box. And everything will restart. It was Bridgeport who scored in the first inning yesterday. The Ducks scoring all three of their runs in the third in the 3-2 win. Another payoff pitch. Swung on, hit on the ground, right side, under the glove of Mayora. Hall comes all the way around to score on an infield single. Mayora diving to his left, knocked it down, but it went underneath him into the outfield, and the Ducks take a 3-0 lead.
Ball game is going out on the center field, number 24, Craig Bennick, number 24.
Few innocent enough balls for the Ducks, but Hall running with the pitch, able to score from second base. Bailey stopped at second as Enriquez drove in a run with that single. Craig Binnick takes the first pitch, fastball outside for ball one. Binnick, the eighth man to bat here in the bottom of the first for the Ducks. They have a 3-0 lead. 1-0. Fastball into the knees for a strike to even the count. For Enriquez, his 16th run batted in this year. Binnick swings the 1-1, fouls it back to the backstop. And now a 1-2 count. Binnick 3-of-14 so far with the Ducks this season. This is fifth game. Joined the team as the second half started. Lines this one just foul down the left field line. Pulled it from the right side. Count stays 1-2. 3-0 Ducks. Two away, bottom of the first. Adam Bailey, the runner on second base with Ralph Enriquez leading off first. Righty-righty matchup. Mike Parisi staring in. Now checks second and fires. Misses high and away. And the count goes to 2-2. That was the 35th pitch of the inning for Parisi. As he steps off to look at Adam Bailey back to second base. So it doesn't look like it will be a long outing for Parisi. 2-2. Swung on, fouled off right side. This one flying onto the concourse. Count remains 2-2. Luckily for Bridgeport, they used just one reliever last night as Hunter Jones went seven innings in the start. Then Winston Abreu came in for the eighth inning of the 3-2 loss. The kick and the 2-2. Bounces all the way to the backstop. Both runners advance on a wild pitch. That fastball was a 58-footer. And it moves Bailey to third and Enriquez to second. Now a full count to Craig Binnick to boot, so the runners can get a head start as well. Parisi nods at second, fires. Binnick takes it low for ball four. Second walk of the inning, another Municipal Credit Union walk with a purpose. Every time a Ducks batter walks, the Quacker Jack Foundation wins. It reloads the bases as Dan Lyon steps up, the shortstop, the nine hitter in the lineup, the ninth man to bat here in the bottom of the first. 3 runs in for Long Island as they take a 3-0 lead. 2 walks, 3 hits in the inning. An error as well, which extended the damage. First pitch, righty Lyons takes it low and away for ball one. The first run will go down as earned, the rest all unearned, as that error by Victor Diaz plays a big role in this bottom of the first. The set, the 1-0. Lyons takes it low again for ball two. Parisi having trouble. Of his first 40 pitches, 21 of them strikes, 19 of them balls. The biggest issue is that all 40 have come here in the first inning. 2-0. Catches the outside corner with that fastball. And now it's a 2-1 count. Lyons hitting 216. Yet to hit a home run. 17 runs driven in for the shortstop. Leads the team, is tied for third in the league with 4 triples. Bases for the Ducks, 2-1. Swung on, hit high in the air, shallow center. Mayor, the second baseman, back. And he makes a backhand catch on a jog to retire the side. 9 Ducks come to the plate. 3 of them score on 3 hits, 1 error, and 3 left on for Long Island. Through 1 inning, the Ducks with a 3-0 lead. Second inning coming your way next on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN.
And they're off. Quacker Jack takes an early lead as they're coming around second. Salas trying to play some catch-up. Here they come up to third. Well, wait a minute. What's going on here? Quacker Jack feeling the effects of the hot weather. He's going to stop for some ice cold car bed. Here comes Salas all the way to home. Quacker Jack is going to be ready for ice cream. And Salas is going to take home the win. Congratulations, Salas. You're taking a prize courtesy of Long Island Sports Academy and Page 16. And that was the Duck Day. Okay, come get to pick up your Pleasures post-game pitch balls. You can purchase your Pleasures post-game pitch balls at the Long Island Ducks Sports Authority Ticket Kiosk on the main concourse behind home plate, or from one of our Long Island Ducks staffers who are roaming the stands and concourse at our ballpark. Balls are only $1, and you can purchase 6 balls for only $5. Make sure you join in the fun right after the game tonight as the Pleasures post-game pitch contest. Remember, you got to be in it to win it.
3-0 Long Island. Start of the second inning here at Bethpage Ballpark. Time for the Ducks Injury Report, brought to you by Island Shore Physical Therapy, the official therapists of the Long Island Ducks. Matt Way still on the inactive list. He has some shoulder stiffness. Ryan Strebe also inactive. He has a wrist injury. James Hauser injured his ankle and had to come out of his last start. Looks like he'll be good to go. He is scheduled to start tomorrow, and there's been no change as of yet from the Ducks coaching staff. Dontrell Willis had a 1-2-3 first inning. The Ducks had 3 runs in their half, and now Willis pitching with a 3-0 lead as he'll face the heart of the order, 4-5-6, Alexis Gomez, Louis Lopez, and James Simmons for the Blue Fish. Here's the lefty Gomez, first pitch from Willis. Left-handed pitcher delivers outside for ball one. Gomez hitting .297 on the year. 6 homers, leads the team with 39 driven in. 1-0 fouled weakly up the first baseline. Doesn't even make it to the coach's box. And the count goes to 1-1. Looks like Willis wants to pick up the pace now that he has a 3-run lead. From the wind, the 1-1 pitch. Swung on, hit on one hop under the glove of shortstop Dan Lyons and into left field for what will likely be ruled a base hit as Lyons just couldn't get there. That was sharply hit right past him, and it is a hit. First hit of the ball game for the Blue Fish. And a leadoff man on here in the top of the second. Ducks up 3-0. Sends up Luis Lopez, the third baseman, hitting .269. 2 homers, 27 driven in for the right-handed bat. Gomez a threat to steal. First pitch fastball high and away for ball one. Gomez, 13 stolen bases, leads the way for Bridgeport. Has been caught stealing just twice. Stole a base yesterday in the 3-2 loss. From the stretch, Willis fires 1-0. Big breaking ball, misses outside and high. Now it's a 2-0 count. Ducks wearing the home white uniforms with green pinstripes. Ducks in script across the chest. A pickoff throw, and Alexis Gomez is picked off. That quick throw from the lefty Willis, not stepping at all, just throwing to first base. Joash Brodin applied the tag, and Gomez picked off 1-3. So now one away. In the top of the second, Ducks up 3-0, nobody on. The pitch. Fastball into the knees. Count to 2-1 to Luis Lopez. From the windup again, 2-1 pitch. Curveball on the outside corner, strike two. Ralph Henriquez did a good job dragging that ball into the strike zone to ensure it was called a strike. Willis ready to go. He winds and fires 2-2. Swung on, hit on, two hops to shortstop. Lyons fields at hip level, throws across the diamond. Joash Brodin fields at first to record the second out of the top of the second inning. Long Island with a 3-0 lead.
Batting in the sixth position.
Here's the center fielder, James Simmons. Right-handed 16. Hitter hitting 258. Three homers, 15 driven in this season. A prolific strikeout rate, 46 strikeouts in 97 at-bats. Takes first pitch, fastball for a strike at the belt. Simmons from Irving, Texas. Kick and the one strike pitch. Swung on and missed. Simmons waving at that fastball on the outside corner from Willis. And the count is 0-2. Dontrell goes behind the mound, applies some rosin to his right forearm, grips the ball in his left hand as he prepares to throw a two-strike pitch. Misses outside with a fastball. Flies all the way to the backstop. And the count's 1-2. Looks like the book on Simmons is to blow the fastball by him. See if Willis tries to do that again here on 1-2. The wind and the 1-2 pitch. Curveball, swung on and missed, strike three. Willis goes with the breaking ball, and he earns his first strikeout of the day. No runs, one hit, but Alexis Gomez was picked off. No one left on base here at the top of the second for the Bluefish, heading to the bottom of the inning. The Ducks with a 3-0 lead here on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN.
To get to enjoy the rest of the game from our Dave & Buster's Best Seat in the House. We are also taking home a prize courtesy of Dave & Buster's. But wait, that's not all. If you're sitting in section 207, where they came from, you're also taking home a prize courtesy of Dave & Buster's. So guys, enjoy our Best Seat in the House and enjoy the Dave & Buster's Best Seat in the House.
And now, fans, take a look at that Duck Vision scoreboard and let's set a video for this word from Newsday.
Get ready to see Newsday in a fresh new way. With a smart design that's easy to read. With more news, more coverage, and more Long Island than ever before. It's a new day, starting with Newsday.
And fans, if you think you have what it takes to pitch for the Long Island Ducks, you can prove it to us while you're here at the ballpark tonight. Just head on down to the end of the first base concourse, just a little bit past the dunk tank. Try the dunk tank, the centrally bounced dunk tank, and then go down to the end of the first base concourse for the Long Island Ducks Fast Pitch Game. You'll receive three throws. Remember now, that's the Long Island Ducks Fast Pitch Game, located at the end of the first base.
Bottom of the second inning here at Bethpage Ballpark. I'm Tom Felice, and the Long Island Ducks have a 3-0 lead. They batted around in the first inning. So leadoff hitter Joash Brodin is leading off. the second inning, just like he did the first. He drew a walk his first time up, was eliminated on a fielder's choice. Switch hitter swings from the left. Mike Parisi, the right-hander on the mound, threw 42 pitches in the first inning. First one is hit foul of first base. Adam Bailey almost falls over the railing trying to pick up that foul ball in the Ducks' dugout. Count 0-1. Brodin with hits in 16 of his last 19 ball games. Rewind the 0-1. Fastball on the outside corner. Count to 0-2. Of those 16 games with hits, Brodin has multiple hits in 11 of them. Two-strike pitch. Breaking ball misses low and away. Count 1-2. Take a look at the other games in the Atlantic League. Bit of a rivalry weekend this weekend. Parisi staring in. Kicks, fires 1-2. Breaking ball high and away, and the count evens up. York is playing Lancaster, and the Revolution have a 4-0 lead over the Barnstormers. That a battle of the Pennsylvania teams. Camden and Somerset, the two Jersey teams, scoreless in the top of the third. 2-2 misses low and away. And now it's a full count. Sugarland, a 3-0 lead over Southern Maryland. That game in the bottom of the third inning. Here it's 3-0 Ducks in the bottom of the second. Joash Rodin is a full count leading off. Payoff pitch. Swung on, cranked, foul, and out of play on the right side. Bounces down near the dunk tank and the speed pitch. Count remains full. Somerset and Camden played a day game that was technically a first half game. Somerset took it 6-2. Makeup game for June 27th. Payoff pitch again. Swung on, hit on the ground, weakly towards second. A high hop for Mayora. Fields at the letters, throws to first. And Joash Rodin is retired to start the bottom of the second. Ducks ahead 3-0. Here's Josh Barfield. He reached on a fielder's choice and scored in the three-run first. Barfield scored when Bailey reached on the error. First pitch. Righty takes a breaking ball high and inside. 4-1. Barfield with hits in 8 of his last 10 ball games. 1-ball pitch. Swung on, cranked on the left field line. Fair ball. Bouncing all the way into the corner. Crum over to pick it up. Barfield slowing up as he cruises into second base with a double. First extra base hit of the game for the Ducks. Josh Barfield on second base with one out. Long Island looking to stretch their 3-0 lead. Sends up Bryant Nelson. He singled and scored in the first. Switch hitter Nelson. Swinging from the left side. Three runs on four hits. Bluefish yet to score, just one hit in the ball game. Nelson swings the first pitch. Hits it high in the air, shallow right. Redmond sprints in. And he makes the catch, running from sunlight into the shadows to retire Nelson, first pitch swinging. Now two down. It'll be the cleanup hitter, Bill Hall.
Ducks left fielder, number six.
Hall had a single
Hall,
to left.
Number six.
That was the ball dropped by the left fielder, Austin Crum. He had to reach up on a sharply hit liner. And he had trouble playing it. Hall knocking dirt out of his right cleat as he steps in from the right side. Barfield leading off second base. Parisi from the stretch and the pitch. Fastball high, 4-1. Hall 2-for-3 last night with the two-run homer that put the Ducks in front for good. This is inside. Now a 2-0 count. Bridgeport in the road grays, blue fish in navy across the chest, navy numbers on the back, gray pants, navy caps with light blue brims. Nice crowd filling Bethpage Ballpark. 2-0. Swung on, fouled off right side and out of play. Count to 2-1. Now just slivers of right field in the sunlight. Everywhere else in the shade. Bit of a hazy sky, but no clouds overhead here at Bethpage Ballpark. Check swing. The pitch is outside. No appeal of a check swing. Now a 3-1 count to Bill Hall. 3-0 Ducks. Two outs. Bottom of the second inning. Josh Barfield leading off second base. Hall ready. 3-1. Swung on and foul tipped into the mitt. Held on by Luis Rodriguez, and the count's gone full. Hall with another home run swing. But it keeps Hall at the plate. Now a full count. Barfield can get a head start from second base. Hall takes off his batting helmet to wipe some sweat off of his head. Payoff pitch. Swung on hit. Weakly foul of first base. Hall swinging at a breaking ball, just making contact. And he stays alive. Tracy reading the sign from the catcher, Luis Rodriguez. Hall climbs in to the batter's box. Payoff pitch again. Swung on and missed. Hall chasing a low slider, and he could not make contact. First strikeout for Mike Parisi, and it ends the bottom of the second. Heading to the third, Ducks ahead 3-0 here on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN.
Happy birthday on the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Liam. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Liam. Now it's time to go ahead and enjoy some caramel ice cream and pizza from Pizza. We also want to give a special shout out to the head chef of the center plate, John Shuchuk. It is also his birthday, so a big shout out to him as well. And if anybody in the park is also celebrating a birthday, a big happy birthday from all of us at the Long Island Ducks. Take a look up there in the Duck Vision scoreboard for all of the birthdays in attendance.
And famous, hoping to get yourself by the New York Rice Concourse table. It's on the many concourse behind home plate.
Top of the third inning, Long Island with a 3-0 lead. And it's time for tonight's third inning trivia brought to you by Carvel. Carvel, so celebrating more than 75 years of making people happy. Dontrell Willis on the mound for the Ducks, finished second in the National League Cy Young Award voting in 2005. Who won the 2005 Cy Young Award in the National League? The answer in the bottom half of the inning. Luis Rodriguez, Victor Diaz, and Iggy Suarez do up for the Bluefish here against Dontrell Willis in the top of the third. Ducks ahead 3-0. Lefty-righty matchup as Willis fires. Curveball on the outside corner. That is strike one. Rodriguez hitting 256, two homers, 22 driven in for the catcher. One strike pitch, fastball into the knees on the outside corner. For strike two, a great fastball, perfectly located by Dontrell Willis. Rodriguez steps out of the batter's box to wipe his brow. Now he's ready. The kick, the 0-2. Slider missing low. Now a 1-2 count. Rodriguez cuffs the pants just below the knee. Navy socks exposed. 1-2. Fastball low. Check swing. No go for Luis Rodriguez. And the count evens up at 2-2. Willis pitching behind an orange glove. Fires 2-2. Swung on line to left field. Hall charges in, but it drops in front of him for a base hit. He fields it on a bounce and flips it back in. Second hit of the game for Bridgeport. They have a man on with nobody out in the top of the third, trailing 3-0. Here's the eight-hitter, Victor Diaz. Averaged down to 192. He is 0 for his last 11. Two homers, 12 driven in for the first baseman. Another right-handed bat. Seven in the lineup versus lefty Dontrell Willis. First pitch fastball misses outside for ball one. Rodriguez not a threat to steal from first base. Takes a very short lead. One ball pitch. Swung on, fisted into the seats right side. Fan in a gray t-shirt ends up with it. There's a small blonde child right next to him. And now that child is the recipient of the baseball. 1-1 count to Diaz. From the stretch, the pitch. Fastball low. Count 2-1. Alexis Gomez led off the last inning with a hit for Bridgeport. Mendontrell Willis picked him off. 2-1. Foul tipped into the mitt. Enriquez holds on behind the plate. And the count back even at 2-2. 3-0 Ducks. Nobody out, man on first, top of the third for the Bluefish. Willis fires. Check swing on the appeal. No swing, rules Matt Hensel, the first base umpire. And as the pitch was low, it's a full count to Victor Diaz. Nelson looks at first, fires 3-2. Swung on and missed. Curveball from Willis. And it earns him his second strikeout of the inning of the day. First of the inning. That's the first out of the inning. Sends up the nine-hitter Iggy Suarez. Shortstop hitting 220 on the year. A homer and 12 driven in. Another right-handed batter. Bryant Nelson, the third baseman, creeping in now even with the bag. About 8 feet off of it. First pitch. That is low for ball one. Dontrell Willis scratched from his most recent start. It was supposed to come Sunday. One ball pitch. Swung on, popped up, skied behind shortstop. Lyons, the shortstop, backing up a few steps on the outfield. Grass makes the catch for the second out of the top of the third. Long Island ahead 3-0. Sends up the top of the order, Daniel Mayora. Second baseman grounded out to second base, leading off the ball game. Bridgeport has a runner on first. Luis Rodriguez led off this inning with a line drive single to left. So Willis was scratched from the start on Sunday. Pete Budkovics made the spot start and performed well. Five innings. First pitch. That is inside. And the count to 1-0. Budkovics gave up five hits in those five innings, three runs, just one of them earned, as he filled an emergency role for the Ducks. One ball pitch, swung on, lined over second base, down into right field for a base hit. Adam Bailey picks it up, loops it back in. Rodriguez stopping at second base on the single for Daniel Mayora, putting two on with two out for Bridgeport, 15, trailing Austin Long Island 3-0. Here in the third inning. Sends up Austin Crum, the left fielder. Popped up to third baseman Bryant Nelson in foul territory. His first time up. And the pitch. Swung on, line foul into the seats. Left side. That ends up on the first concourse. Young man in a blue t-shirt ends up with it. He holds it high above his head to celebrate his souvenir. Crum and Willis will be teammates in the All-Star game. One strike pitch. Swung on, hit weakly on the ground towards first. Brodeen Fields takes it to the bag himself and beats Crum by two steps to end the inning. No runs on two hits, no errors. Two left on for Bridgeport in the top of the third inning, heading to the bottom half of the frame. Long Island with a 3-0 lead here on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN.
Fans, you gotta cheer Reese on. 30 seconds on the clock. And go! First one's a little overthrown, but it's still okay. Plenty of time left on the clock. Coming down to 23 seconds now. Fans, you gotta cheer Reese on and help him out. Overthrown, coming up now in 15 seconds. And you gotta run the first one. Coming back to number two with coming up on 10 seconds. Back to number three. 5 seconds on the clock. And he doesn't get it. But you know what, fans? We're going to give him the prize anyway. Congratulations. You're taking home courtesy of Huntington Honda. And that is the Balloon Birds.
Bottom of the third inning at the Duck Pond. Long Island with a 3-0 lead over Bridgeport. It's time for the answer to tonight's third inning trivia brought to you by Carvel. Carvel celebrating more than 75 years of making people happy. The question, who came in first in Cy Young Award voting in 2005 when Dontrell Willis, the Ducks starter tonight, came in second? The answer, Chris Carpenter of the St. Louis Cardinals. Carp won the 2005 Cy Young Award right in front of Dontrell Willis. Right fielder Adam Bailey leading things off here in the bottom of the third. Long Island with a 3-0 lead. Bailey swinging from the left side, the only pure lefty in the lineup for the Ducks tonight. First pitch. That strike on the outside corner. Bailey reached on an error in the first inning, and that extended that three-run frame. It was an error by the first baseman, Victor Diaz, 0-1. Fastball misses low, and the count evens up. If Diaz had made a play, it would have just been the second out of the inning. But Ray Navarette on deck hit a sacrifice fly, which would have ended the inning without the error. 1-1 misses outside. Now a 2-1 count. So because of that, just one of the three runs in the first inning goes down as earned on Mike Parisi's ledger. The righty winds and fires. Bailey swings, lines one deep to right. Redmond going back at the track. He looks up. This one's off the wall. Bailey sprinting for second base. Redmond throws it in. Bailey standing on second base with a double. Adam Bailey leading off the bottom of the third with a double for the Ducks as they look to stretch a 3-0 lead. Here's the DH, Ray Navarette. Hit a sacrifice fly to center in the first, driving in the second of the three runs in that frame. Ray Navarette, a right-handed hitter, the DH today. Takes first pitch fastball outside for ball one. Navarette has been the designated hitter the past five ball games, yet to play in the field since returning from the inactive list. Curveball high and inside. Counts 2-0. Navarette will, of course, know Parisi very well. Parisi, a member of the Ducks in 2011. From the stretch, 2-0. Swung on, hit up the third baseline. Two hops for Lopez. Strong throw across the diamond. Ends up low, and Victor Diaz cups it right at the ground level. But it retires Navarette, and Bailey can't advance from second base. That's the first out of the bottom of the third inning. Ducks ahead 3-0.
Ducks catcher number 30, Ralph Enriquez.
Here's Ralph Enriquez, the catcher. He singled under the glove of Daniel Mayora, the second baseman, in the first and drove in a run That was the third run. As he swings and misses at the first pitch here. Enriquez ending up at a knee, almost corkscrewing himself into the ground. A one. Fastball low and the count evens up. Adam Bailey on first base after his leadoff double for the Ducks. Mike Parisi from the stretch. Sets at the belt. Checks second. Fires 1-1. Change up outside. Two-one count to Enriquez. Slightly open stance on the left side for the switch-hitting catcher. And 2-1 pitch. Fastball on the outside corner. That evens the count at 2-2. Kevin Baez facing towards Bailey, the runner at second. 2-2, swung on, hit on. Two hops to first. Diaz fields backing up, flips to Parisi, the pitcher covering. That retires Enriquez. Bailey up to third on that ground out. And it sends up Craig Binnick with a man on third, two down, bottom of the third inning. Ducks ahead 3-0. Binnick drew a full count walk his first time up. Slightly closed stance from the right side for the center fielder. First pitch. Swing on, lined up the middle, and it's down for a base hit in front of James Simmons. Bailey comes in to score, and the Ducks take a 4-0 lead. Craig Binnick, first pitch swinging, sent it right back up the middle, and he drives in his third run of the year, and the Ducks take a 4-0 lead. Here's the nine-hitter Dan Lyons, batting for the second time in just three innings. Mike Parisi having a rough go of it on the mound for Bridgeport. This will be pitch number 73. He's recorded just 8 outs. First pitch. Righty Lyons takes a strike on the outside corner. Binnick held on first base by Victor Diaz. Binnick 1-of-1 in stolen base attempts in 5 games this season. One strike pitch. Swung on, hit on the ground towards short. Suarez fields moving right, throws to second. And that forces out Craig Binnick and ends the frame for the Ducks.
Here's what you should do.
One run on 2 hits, no errors, 1 left on for Long Island. And through 3 full, the Ducks have a 4-0 lead here on the home of the Ducks. 103.9 RCN.
On the main concourse behind home plate, show me your book, the pork chop, and claim your prize, courtesy of Menchie's Frozen Yogurt. Now, Menchie's is yogurt your way, so make sure to visit their location at Lindenhurst. It's in the Sunrise Plaza Shopping Center on Willard Avenue, just north of Sunrise Highway, in the Outback Steakhouse Shopping Center. Now, remember, that's Menchie's yogurt your way. Make sure to visit their location at Lindenhurst, just north of Sunrise Highway on Lower Avenue in the Sunrise Plaza Shopping Center. And remember, hang on to tonight's ticket stub because that'll give you 10% off your purchase at Menchie's. And then don't forget, Tommy, that Dunk Tank Food is waiting for you. He's very nasty tonight. I don't know, he must have got up on the wrong side of the bed or something, but he's over there, and he wants you to try to dunk him into that cool water in the dunk tank, presented by Send It the Clown. That's the Send It the Clown's dunk tank, located along the first base concourse, with Tommy, the dunk tank dude. He's there waiting for you.
Four nothing Ducks at the start of the fourth inning. Here at Bethpage Ballpark, I'm Tom Felice. Dontrell Willis on the mound for Long Island. And Prentice Redmond stepping in from the right side. Redmond, Alexis Gomez, and Louis Lopez due up here in the fourth inning for the Bluefish, 3, 4, and 5 in the order. Willis winds and fires. First pitch, high and away for ball one. Redmond grounded out to first base, his first time up. One ball offering. Misses outside, now it's 2-0. Past four starts have gone swimmingly for Dontrell Willis. Two ball pitch. Curveball on the outside corner. Count now 2-1. In those four starts, Willis throwing 27 innings, giving up just 4 earned runs. 2-1. Breaking ball misses inside. Now a 3-1 count. 19 strikeouts in those 27 innings. 17 hits allowed. 3-1. Swung on, flown to deep right. Bailey backpedaling, and the right fielder grabs it in his tracks to retire Redmond, leading off the top of the fourth. Bluefish down 4-0. Here's the DH, Alexis Gomez, one of two lefties in the lineup. He singled under the glove of the shortstop Dan Lyons his first time up and was promptly picked off first base. First pitch, Willis delivers a breaking ball on the outside corner. That's strike one. Gomez 2-for-4 with a home run last night. Swings the 0-1 pitch and skies it to center. Binnick a few shuffles to his left. One back pedal and he makes the catch. So two flyouts here in the top of the fourth, both of them directly at outfielders. Dontrell Willis looking really good as he holds a 4-0 lead in the fourth inning. Willis rounding into form, certainly a candidate to start the Atlantic League All-Star game. Kevin Baez, the Ducks manager, is the manager of the All-Star team. As Willis throws a first pitch ball low to Louis Lopez, Baez, the manager of the Liberty Division squad, so he has the choice of who will start. One ball pitch. Swung on, hit sharply on one hop to the third base coach, Willie Upshaw, who makes a fine play with his right hand, and then the lefty flips it into the crowd. Count evens up, 1-1 to Lopez. He grounded out to short his first time up. Willis winds and deals 1-1. Breaking ball misses outside. And now a 2-1 count. Willis came into this game with a 4-3 record, a 2.91 earned run average. Just fell out of the top 10 in ERA because he wasn't eligible. 2-1. Swung on, popped up weakly behind home plate and out of play. Count 2-2. Usually you need to have thrown an average of 0.8 innings per game. So at this point in the season, 74 games, it would be 59 2/3 innings to be eligible. Willis came into the game with 58.2. 2-2 pitch, just low. And the count's gone full, so Willis should be back in the pitching top 10 for ERA after this outing. 3-2. Swung on, hit on the ground. One hop to Willis. He snags it with the glove. Throws to first, and that retires the side. Lopez with one he thought was ticketed for center, but instead it just ended up in that orange mitt of Dontrell Willis. Heading to the bottom of the fourth, Ducks ahead 4-0 here at Bethpage Ballpark, and you're listening to it on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN.
Congratulations, Danny, and thank you for playing PC Richardson. What's in the box?
the appliance electronic computer, Shiny.
And baseball fans up on the Duck Fishing scoreboard in left center field of tonight's groups in attendance. The Long Island Ducks would like to thank each group for their valuable support, especially the big group from Everbank, tonight's game sponsor. Thank you for joining us, and thank you for sponsoring tonight's ball game, giving away those 1,500 Long Island Duck travel mugs. Thank you, Everbank. If you're interested in bringing a group to a ballpark this season, please stop by the Sports Authority Ticket Kiosk on the main concourse behind home plate for more information how you can bring your group.
4-0 Long Island, bottom of the fourth, starting up. Fans, discover the real difference at Huntington Honda West and get straight down the middle savings on Long Island's number one lineup of Honda-certified used cars. Huntington Honda West doesn't play games or small ball. Check out their giant indoor showroom along with hundreds of premium used vehicles available at HuntingtonHondaCars.com or head out to Huntington Honda West on Jericho Turnpike, just a half mile east of Route 110. Top of the order, Joe Ashbrodine. Here in the fourth for the Ducks. Mike Parisi still on the mound. He's thrown 74 pitches through just three innings. First pitch, curveball, a strike on the outside corner. Brodine, the switch hitter, bats from the left side. 0 for 1 with a walk. Swings to this one, lines it to left. Crum a few staggered steps in, and he makes the grab to retire Brodine. A quick first out here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Ducks ahead 4-0. Setting up the second baseman, Josh Barfield. He's 1-for-2, reached on a fielder's choice and scored in the first. Had a double to left down the line in the second, but was stranded on second base. Swings the first pitch, fouls it. Back to the backstop. Count 0-1. Mike Parisi went to Sachem North High School, so he's a local Long Island product. One strike pitch. Curveball misses high. The count is 1-1. He then went to Manhattan College in the Bronx. Had a very good career, drafted in the ninth round in 2004. 1-1 popped up. Down the right field line, second baseman Mayora over towards the line, and he makes a two-hand catch some 10 feet off the chalk to retire Barfield for the second out of the bottom of the fourth inning. Long Island with a 4-0 lead. Manhattan College and their baseball program has a claim to fame, or at least a claimed claim to fame. It's still in dispute, but the story goes that way back in the 19th century, they invented the seventh-inning stretch. Mike Parisi not happy with the baseball, so he gets another one. Brother Jasper was the head coach and the prefect of discipline at Manhattan College. So he was in charge of the students, and one day they got a little restless, so he told them to stand up. First pitch fastball. Goes high to Bryant Nelson, and the count 1-0, and from then on, the seventh-inning stretch became a regular thing. One ball pitch misses inside. 2-0 count to Nelson. Manhattan College often played at the Polo Ground, so the seventh-inning stretch drew some acclaim, and it's been seen everywhere ever since. Nelson swings the 2-0, slices a liner to left center field. Crum over from left, and he makes the catch to retire Nelson and the Ducks. 1-2-3 in the fourth inning. An efficient inning for Mike Parisi. He threw just 8 pitches to set down the Ducks. 1-2-3. Heading to the fifth. Ducks ahead 4-0 here on the home of the Ducks. 103.9 RCN.
Bears furniture.
And fans would like to give a special hello and a howdy here to you to the fans from Francis Vecchione's 65th birthday who are partying down to the Smoking Owl's parking deck area. Make sure you stop by the Sports Authority Ticket Kiosk on the winning concourse behind home plate to get more information about this exclusive party area. It's the ultimate way to enjoy a Long Island Ducks game. Francis, happy birthday from the Long Island Ducks. And fans, don't forget the Pritchard Group will be here again tomorrow evening, game time 5:05. The gates open up at 4:05. Get here early. Get the autographs and favorite players.
Top of the fifth inning, Ducks with a 4-0 lead here at Bethpage Ballpark. Dontrell Willis twirling a great outing, giving up just 3 hits so far, and he has yet to walk a batter. Be James Simmons, Louis Rodriguez, and Victor Diaz here for the Bluefish in the top of the fifth. Simmons struck out swinging his first time up. Lefty Willis ready on the hill. Simmons just now climbing in from the right side. Takes fastball outside for ball one. Fans, don't forget to stop by the Waddle Inn Shop on your next visit to the Duck Pond. One ball pitch, swing and a miss. Count evens up at the Waddle Inn Shop. Exclusive hard-to-find Ducks memorabilia is now on sale. Proceeds benefit the Quackerjack Foundation, the charitable arm of the Long Island Ducks. Willis ready to go, the 1-1. That misses low and away, and now it's a 2-1 count. So be sure to stop in the Waddle Inn Shop. See the great Jay Randall, Zach Jennis, and the rest of their staff for all of your Ducks merchandise needs. 2-1 pitch on the way. Simmons swings and misses at an inside breaking ball, and the count goes to 2-2. 4-0 Ducks, nobody out. Top of the fifth. Simmons takes off his batting helmet, readjusts it first with the brim, then at the top of the head. The kick, the 2-2. Swung on line, foul, concourse right side, almost into the foul line fair concession stand. Bounces out into the middle of the concourse. A young fan ends up the recipient of that foul ball. Willis going to the rosin bag behind the mound, climbing back up to the rubber. The wind, the kick, the 2-2. Swung on line up the middle. And down for a base hit in front of Craig Binnick in center field. That one right over the head of Dontrell Willis. As the ball is thrown back in, a single for James Simmons leading off the fifth inning. There have been leadoff singles 3 of the past 4 innings. But the Bluefish yet to have a man past second base. Willis and the catcher Ralph Enriquez having a brief chit-chat. Willis seeming to say that pitch was my bad on the one that Simmons lined to center. 4-0 Long Island, one on, nobody out for Bridgeport in the top of the fifth. Louis Rodriguez, the catcher in from the right side, swings the first pitch, hits it on 2 hops to short. Lyons slips to second for 1. Barfield on to first, double play. Dontrell Willis pointing at Ralph Enriquez, signifying that Enriquez knew what pitch to throw right there and induce the 6-4-3 double play just like that. 2 down, top of the fifth. Ducks with the 4-0 lead. It's interesting, Ramon Castro, the former major leaguer, but Ralph Enriquez has caught Dontrell Willis now 8 of his 11 starts. Victor Diaz stands in from the right side. First pitch, swing and a miss. Healthy cut at a fastball. But Willis avoiding the bat of Diaz for strike 1. First time up, Diaz struck out swinging. 1 strike pitch. Fastball misses outside. That evens the count. Willis fell off the mound to the third base side a little bit, looking like he might have overthrown that pitch. The twist in the 1-1. Outside again with the fastball. Now a 2-1 count. Mentioned last inning, Willis will become eligible again for the ERA leaders. The ERA leader in the Atlantic League, Matt Wright of Sugarland, signed by the Royals organization today. 2-1. Curveball outside. And now a 3-1 pitch. Jason Bergman, the closer for Sugarland, also signed today. So the Skeeters losing two. Curveball just misses outside. Willis with a long look in as he issues his first walk of the ball game to Victor Diaz. And the Bluefish have a man on first with two away in the top of the fifth inning. Ducks with a 4-0 lead. Here's the nine-hitter, Iggy Suarez. He popped up to short his first time out. Willis had an issue with walks early in the season, but he slowed that down. Had just one walk in seven innings last time out against Bridgeport when he took the tough luck loss. Fastball, a strike at the letters. Count 0-1 to Suarez. Suarez, a right-handed hitter. Willis from the stretch, kicks and deals. Fastball outside corner. He's quickly ahead 0-2. In his past four starts, working backwards, Willis with one walk, two walks, three walks, four walks. Going downhill, 0-2. Outside. And it's a 1-2 count to Iggy Suarez. He had a five-game hitting streak snapped with his 0-for-3 outing last night. 1-2. Curveball missing low. And the count evens at 2-2. Victor Diaz, the runner on first base for the Bluefish, looking for their first run, trailing 4-0 to the Ducks after the Ducks took game one of the series 3-2 yesterday. 2-2 count to Iggy Suarez. The high kick and the pitch. Check swing, called strike three. Alan Reyes waiting two beats or three before ringing up the batter, Iggy Suarez, and ending the top of the fifth. Dontrell Willis with another strikeout. And it ends the top of the fifth. No runs on one hit, no errors, one walk, and one left on for Bridgeport. This one's halfway home and official. Heading to the bottom of the fifth, the Ducks with a 4-0 lead.
And we would just like to thank Everest Bank one more time for those great travel mugs that the first 1,500 fans came through. Those things are great. Enjoy them to everybody. So we're coming up now. 8, 9, and 10. And they're off. He's making a mad dash for it. And it's over. Mike has taken on the prize courtesy of D'Antoni Industries. Remember D'Antoni Industries for all your battery needs.
And fans, don't forget to stop by the table in front of the Water Wind Shop on the main concourse right behind home plate and pick up some 50-50 raffle tickets. We're going to announce the winner at the end of the seventh inning, and you must be present to redeem your prize. It's $1 a ticket or $5 for six tickets, and all the proceeds will go to the Cracker Jack Foundation, charitable arm of the Long Island Ducks. Remember now, that's the table in front of the Water Wind Shop to pick up your 50-50 raffle tickets. And while you're up there by the Water Wind Shop on the main concourse behind home plate, make sure you bid on this year's special patriotic jerseys that the team wore on the 4th of July. Those same jerseys are being auctioned off to benefit the Cracker Jack Foundation. So visit the Water Wind Shop tonight to bid on your favorite Ducks jersey. Batting for your luck on the Ducks, here's the left fielder number 6. Bill Hall, number 6.
Bill Hall leading off the bottom of the fifth for Long Island. The Ducks with a 4-0 lead. Shortstop steps in from the right side. Check that. Hall in left field tonight. He's 1-for-2. Singled and scored in the 3-run first. Struck out to end the second. Swings at the first pitch and waves at a fastball from Mike Parisi. High fastball, Hall chasing. And the count to 0-1. The wind in the 0-1. Catch the outside corner. Quickly 0-2. A righty-righty matchup here as Parisi on the hill was helped generously by an 8-pitch fourth inning. His pitch count now at 82. But that looks a lot better than the 74 through three innings as his night began. Oh, 2. Called strike 3 on the outside corner. Hall knew it right away. And he walks to the dugout after watching that curveball curl in there for a strike. Second strikeout of the day for Mike Parisi. Now one away, bottom of the fifth. Long Island ahead, 4-0. Dontrell Willis pitching rather well tonight for the Ducks. Here's Adam Bailey. Been on base twice. First time via an error that he doubled and scored in the third. Takes a strike to the knees. And count to 0-1. Looks like Alan Reyes' strike zone has expanded a little bit as this game has moved on. Another strike at the knees. Parisi with another fastball. Bailey quickly behind 0-2. 5 pitches this inning, all of them in the zone from Parisi. Ducks had to make contact with any of those pitches. 0-2. That is low for a ball. And now to 1-2 count. From the wind, the twist, and the 1-2. Swung on and missed. Bailey waving at a breaking ball on the outside corner. Second strikeout of the inning, third overall for Mike Parisi. And there are 2 Ducks down in the bottom of the fifth. Nobody on. 4-0 lead for Long Island as Ray Navarette steps up. Navarette 0-for-1, hit a sacrifice fly. Driving the second of 3 runs in the first. Rounded out in the third. Curveball. Breaks on to the inside corner for strike 1. Parisi working at a quick pace. Fires the 1-strike pitch. Swung on, cranked down the left field line, but pulled well foul. That landing down by the bounce house. Deep down the left field line. 0-2 quickly to Ray Navarette. Righty-righty matchup. Parisi nods in agreement with his catcher Rodriguez and now steps off. Quackerjack, the Ducks mascot, standing on the first base dugout trying to put the whammy on Mike Parisi, waving those arms in front of his Duck body. Now it's Navarette calling time at home plate. He steps off. 0-2. Misses low. 1-2 count to Navarette. Fifth game back for Ray. He missed almost all of June. Fastball low, and it's a 2-2 count. Plantar fasciitis keeping Navarette on the pine. But he's back and ready to go for the second half of the season. 2-2. Curveball swung on line to center. Simmons with 2 steps in, and he grabs it to retire the side. Another rather easy inning for Mike Parisi, throwing 12 pitches to set down the Ducks. 1-2-3. Through 5 full, the Ducks ahead 4-0 here at Bethpage Ballpark. You're listening on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN.
There's no crime in baseball. Any questions before we get started? Any questions? Not about your...
You know what else is nice? Saving money on car insurance with Geico. Geico, see how much you can save.
And fans, don't forget to stop by to the Yard Life Concourse table. It's on the main concourse right next to the New City Customer Service Center. Bring your children with you and have them sign up for the Child ID program brought to you by our good friends from New York Life. Now each family participating in the program, the entered and winning official Long Island Ducks baseball from Duck Circuit Baseman Josh Barfield. And remember, that's the New York Life Concourse table. It's on the concourse next to the Newsday Customer Service Center. Make sure you stop by and fill out that raffle form so that you can win that special baseball, that autographed baseball from second baseman Josh Barfield. And boys and girls, congratulations tonight to the Bethpage Kids Club winner. That's Landon Aponte. Landon Aponte, congratulations from the Long Island Ducks. You stop by the Sports Authority Ticket Kiosk, main concourse behind home plate, and pick up your Long Island Ducks autographed baseball. Boys and girls, for more information, now you can join Cracker Jack and become a member of the Bethpage Kids Club. Stop by the Sports Authority ticket kiosk on the main.
Top of the sixth inning, the Ducks with a 4-0 lead over the Bridgeport Bluefish. Fans follow all season long as the Ducks try to meet the Chappies Home Run Challenge. If the Ducks hit 100 home runs, Chappies Funeral Homes will donate $5,000 to the Quacker Jack Foundation. Chappies Funeral Homes, where caring for others is our family tradition. The Ducks have 75 home runs this season in game number 75 of the 140-game season. So it looks like the Ducks are well on their way to meeting the Chappies Home Run Challenge. Eric Threets out of the bullpen. The day done for Dontrell Willis. He went just five innings, gave up four hits, no runs, one walk, three strikeouts, 73 pitches only for Dontrell Willis. He leaves the ball game, giving way to Eric Threets. Ducks up 4-0. So Willis is in line for the win as the sixth inning begins. Top of the order, second baseman Daniel Mayora, right-handed batter against the lefty Threets. First pitch, fastball inside for ball one. Of those 73 pitches for Willis, 42 of them strikes. Mayora 1-for-2 in the ball game. The pitch, fastball high, and now a 2-0 count. Lefty Threets on the season, making his fourth appearance, all in relief for the Ducks. He has thrown 2 1/3 innings, giving up four hits, seven runs, but just two of them earned. Two ball pitch. Fastball on the inside corner. Now the count's 2-1. Threets with one strikeout versus three walks so far in his time with the Ducks. Pitching just from the stretch. 2-1 home. Mayora swings, pulls it on the ground, two hops to short. High throw from Lyons, but not too high for Joash Brodeen, and Mayora retired, leading off the top of the sixth inning.
The fielder, number 15,
Ducks ahead 4-0. Threets last pitched on Wednesday. Through 2/3 of an inning, gave up two hits, four runs, but just one of them earned in that game against the Somerset Patriots, which the Ducks lost by the score of 8-1. Here's Austin Crum, the left fielder, batting from the left side as Daniel Mayora has a few words for Alan Reyes as he crosses behind him, heading back to the third base dugout after grounding out. First pitch. Crum takes a strike on the outside corner. That is strike one. Crum 0-for-2 in the ball game. Foul popped to third base and a ground out to first. 0-1 pitch, fastball high, on the count 1-1. So Kevin Baez following the lefty starter Dontrell Willis with another lefty, Eric Threets. Slightly open stance for Crum, 1-1. Swung on, fisted, foul, and out of play. Behind the plate on the left side, count to 1-2. Bryant Nelson plays third for the Ducks. Dan Lyons at shortstop, Josh Barfield at second, Joash Brodeen at first, Bill Hall, Craig Binnick, Adam Bailey left to right in the outfield with Ralph Enriquez catching. 1-2. Swung on, fisted pop, Threets dives, comes up short, and the ball rolling towards the third base line, and it stays fair on the dirt. Bryant Nelson touches it and kicks it into foul territory. It'll be a bloop infield single for Austin Crum. Fifth hit of the ball game for Bridgeport. A valiant effort by Threets as he sprinted off the mound to right his right, dove, came up about 6 inches short. And Crum has a hit. A man on with a man out in the top of the sixth for Bridgeport. The Ducks with a 4-0 lead. Here's the three-hitter, Prentice Redman. Right fielder 0-for-2, ground out to first. And a fly out to right, so he's gone the opposite way with no success in his two at-bats tonight. Second baseman Barfield inches towards the bag, first pitch. Breaking ball misses inside for ball one. from 6 of 9 in stolen base attempts on the season. Would not think this would be a time that Willie Upshaw would send him from first, especially with the lefty on the mound. 1-ball pitch, fastball low. Now it's 2-0. Looked like Threets might have overthrown that one a little bit as he sort of tumbled down the slope of the mound. 4-0 Long Island, one out, top of the sixth. Runner on first base for the Bridgeport Bluefish. 2-0. Fastball. Strike on the outside corner. And the count to 2-1. Threets playing in the majors in 2007, 2008, and 2010. First 2 years with the Giants, then with the White Sox in 2010. 2-1. Curveball swung on and missed. Redmond fooled by that pitch. And the count's to 2-2. Threets pitches with a sleeve on his left arm covering his elbow. Right arm exposed. Lefty fires 2-2. Swung on, hit high in the air, deep to left. Hall going back towards the warning track. He reaches up and makes the catch, tapping the Newsday sign in left field before throwing it back in. Redmond sent that ball a long way, but it is a long out for the second out of the top of the sixth. Long Island with a 4-0 lead. Austin Crump still on first base as the DH Alexis Gomez steps up. Gomez 1-for-2 against the starter Dontrell Willis. Singled under the glove of the shortstop Lyons, was promptly picked off in the second inning and flied out to center field in the fourth. First pitch from Threets. Curveball misses low and away, 4-1. Infield shifted around towards the right side. Bryant Nelson well off the line at third. Josh Barfield deep in the hole at second. 1-ball pitch. That is low. Enriquez quickly out of the crouch. Crum not moving from first base. And Gomez is ahead in the count, 2-0. Gomez with an open stance. Black batting gloves. 2-ball pitch. Swung on, sliced foul down the left field line and out of play, bouncing off the first concourse all the way up onto the second concourse. Gomez, very solid looking player. Two-one pitch, here it is. Slice to left again, this one playable. Bill Hall with a few steps into his right, and he grabs it, and that retires the side. No runs on a hit, no errors. One left on for the Bluefish in the top of the sixth inning. Heading to the bottom half of the frame, Long Island ahead 4-0 here on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN.
And fans, here's the best part. You're going to be my judges. So whenever we're ready, let's hit the music up there for Mary Beth. If you guys know the song, you can sing along now.
Reach out, touching me.
Here we go, man.
Courtesy of
Long Island with a 4-0 lead as the bottom of the sixth starts up here at Bethpage Ballpark. It will be the bottom third of the order for the Long Island Ducks. The Ducks play their last game before the All-Star break tomorrow here at Bethpage Ballpark at 5:05. Tickets are still available. There will be pregame autographs on the field, and postgame kids and kids at heart can run the bases. Presented by Bethpage Federal Credit Union. If you need tickets, stop by the Bethpage Ballpark box office, go to liducks.com, or give the box office a call, 631-940-TIXX. That's 631-940-8499. Benny, Brad, Chris, Anthony, and Sean will fulfill all of your Ducks ticket needs. Switch to Ralph Enriquez, bats from the left side against Mike Parisi, Salama Hill. First pitch, fastball away. 4-1. Enriquez 1-for-2, drove in a run with a single in the 3-run first, then grounded out to first base in the third. 1-ball pitch, swung on and missed. Enriquez out in front of a changeup, and the count runs even. Enriquez has taken a few healthy cuts that have come up empty in this one. 1-1. Fastball high and away. Now a 2-1 count. Ducks with a 4-0 lead here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Parisi ready. He winds, and time is called at home plate. And it's been a familiar refrain for Mike Parisi. When he's on the mound, it seems like the Bluefish just can't score. They did last time out when he got 12 runs in support. 2-1, swung on, sky to deep right center field. Simmons over from center, backing up and gives way to Prentice Redmond, who cannot make the play. That ball falls, and Enriquez reaches. An odd play out there, but a hit for Enriquez, his second hit of the ball game, as there was a mix-up between James Simmons and Prentice Redmond. Looked like Simmons couldn't find it, and Redmond just couldn't get there in time. Leadoff hit, a single for Enriquez, sending up Craig Binnick, the center fielder. 1-for-1 with a walk and a single. Mike Parisi doesn't like the baseball. He throws it into the first base dugout. Right down the steps, an accurate toss from Parisi. 4-0 Long Island. Nobody out, man on first, bottom of the sixth. Binnick takes the first pitch curveball, low and away. 4-1. Mentioned last time out, the Bluefish won 12-5, the last Parisi start, that is. But they had lost the 10 starts before that. And in those 10 starts, there's 24 total runs in support of Mike Parisi. 2-ball pitch. Binnick bunts it foul behind the plate. He was bunting for a hit there, trying to push it up the first baseline. But it goes foul for a 2-1 count. The Bluefish won the first three starts for Mike Parisi this season, scoring a total of 11 runs in those three games. Then they lost the next 10. Bridgeport had a 14-game losing streak at the end of May. 2-1. Binnick bunts again right in front of home plate. Rodriguez picks it up, throws to second base, and that eliminates Enriquez. Luis Rodriguez, known for his defensive prowess, and he shows it there as he fired to second to eliminate the lead runner. Binnick reaches on the fielder's choice, and Ralph Enriquez retired at second base. Since the nine-hitter Dan Lyons, Ducks ahead 4-0. One down now with a runner on first here in the bottom of the sixth. Righty-righty matchup. Parisi from the stretch and the pitch. Swung on, slicing down the right field line into the seats. First row and out of play. Long run over for Prentice Redmond. On that pitch, Binnick took off and then stopped. He has to be careful. Luis Rodriguez, known as the machete for the way he cuts down the runners on the base paths, will have no issue throwing down to first on a pickoff attempt. Throw over to first base from Parisi, and Binnick is back in, standing up. One strike pitch. Swung on, grounded. Weakly towards short. Suarez moves right and bobbles the ball. He kept moving right, trying to get it so he could forehand it instead of backhand. And when he did, he just kind of knocked the ball with his glove. Would expect that to be an error. Binnick ending up on second base and Lyons on first. And it is ruled an E6, allowing Lyons to reach and Binnick to move up. And here comes a big mound visit. Mike Parisi has taken one on the chin a little bit here. He's thrown 103 pitches, and he trails 4-0 as the Ducks bat in the bottom of the sixth inning. But at the top of the order, Joash Brodin stepping in. Brodin 0-2, has a walk. First pitch. That is low, 4-1. Brodin, a switch hitter, batting from the left side against Mike Parisi, the right-handed pitcher. Check of second base, the 1-1 pitch. That is low, and now a 2-0 count. The walk in the first inning for Brodin was his 28th. He leads the team in that category. Check of second from the stretch, the 2-0. Change up on the outside corner. Now the count's 2-1. Greg Binnick on second base. Dan Lyons on first for the Ducks. Parisi, a former teammate of Binnick, looks at him as he leads off second. The 2-1 hit on two hops to second base. Mayoros only plays the first, and that retires Brodin. Both runners advance, Binnick to third and Lyons to second. Now two away, bottom of the sixth inning. Ducks with a 4-0 lead. It'll be up to Josh Barfield to drive in the two men on base. Barfield 1-for-3, reached on a fielder's choice and scored in the first. Ducks with 3 runs in that inning. Barfield then doubled in the second inning. Popped out to second base in the fourth. Righty swings the first pitch, grounds it sharply. Foul of third base. Kevin Baez, the third base coach, hops out of the way. Counts 0-1. Barfield, 6 feet tall, 185 pounds, out of Scottsdale, Arizona. Will turn 31 in December. One strike pitch. Curveball high, and the count evens up. Barfield came up in the Padres organization, was always a highly touted prospect. Had one great year in the Cal League, and really shot his stock up. Another pitch high. Now the count is 2-1. Barfield played 4 years in the big leagues with the Cleveland Indians and the aforementioned San Diego Padres. Stretch in the 2-1. Swung on, popped up, shallow left. Shortstop Suarez holding up his hand, signaling, I got it, and he does as he runs towards the line. To retire Barfield and the Ducks in the bottom of the sixth through six full innings. Long Island with a 4-0 lead here on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN.
It's up to you, the Duck fans, to be our judges. Let's put 20 seconds on my clock. On your mark, get set, go! All right, fans, you gotta make lots of noise because you're gonna be my judges as we're coming up on 15 seconds. and that is Messiest Face.
And fans, tonight's Clubhouse meal is sponsored by the Grill Room. The Grill Room is located at 160 Adams Avenue in Hoppog. Now remember, for fine dining, make sure to visit the Grill Room in Hoppog. The Loyal Ducks thank the Grill Room for their valuable support tonight. That's the Grill Room at 160 Adams Avenue in Hoppog. Thank you for providing tonight's Clubhouse meal. Fans, don't forget the Bridgeport Bluefish will be here again tomorrow. Game time 5:05. The game's open at 4:05.
Ian Snell out of the bullpen for the seventh inning at Bethpage Ballpark. The Long Island Ducks with a 4-0 lead over the Bluefish. He relieves Eric Threets, who threw one inning and gave up one hit, and that was it for Threets. So now it's Ian Snell to pitch the seventh on the season. Snell out of the bullpen, 29 appearances. 4.25 ERA, an 0-1 record, and 29 and 2/3 innings. He has given up 23 hits, 16 runs, 14 of them earned, 30 strikeouts versus 7 walks. It'll be Luis Lopez, James Simmons, and Luis Rodriguez, 5, 6, and 7 for the Bluefish, trailing Long Island 4-0 here at the start of the 7th. Snell, a righty on the hill. Lopez, a righty in the batter's box. First pitch, fastball. Low and in for ball one. Lopez 0-for-2 in the ballgame, 2 ground outs. Both of those at-bats coming against the starter, Dontrell Willis. 1-0. Fastball on the inside corner, 4-to-strike. And the count evens up at 1-1. Snell last pitched last night in the Ducks 3-2 win. 1-1. That misses outside with the breaking ball. And the count's 2-1. Snell struck out 2 batters in his 1 inning of relief. Also gave up a run. It was a home run to Alexis Gomez, the first man he faced in the 7th. 2-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. Another breaking ball outside. And Snell induces the swinging strike. Ian Snell gets a lot out of his 5-11 frame. Wears full black sleeves underneath the white jersey. 2-2, swung on and missed, strike 3. Lopez swinging through an off-speed pitch. First strikeout of the day for Snell. 4th overall for Ducks pitching. And there's one out in the top of the 7th inning. The Ducks with a 4-0 lead. Ducks fans, do you want frequent updates on team transactions, scores, store specials, and the status of upcoming games? Then follow the Long Island Ducks on Twitter at twitter.com/LIDucks. With Twitter, the faithful flock will also be able to follow their Ducks and find out more information regarding nightly promotions, player signings, league activities, and more. The Ducks are tweeting right now, and you can follow along at twitter.com/LIDucks. James Simmons swings the first pitch and skies it to left center field. Hall trots in and the left fielder makes a one-hand catch to retire Simmons. And that's the second out of the top of the 7th. Bridgeport down 4-0.
Catcher number 9, Luis Rodriguez. Number 9.
Here's Luis Rodriguez, the catcher, member of the 2004 Atlantic League champion Long Island Ducks. 1-for-2 in the ballgame, singled in the third inning, grounded into a 6-4-3 double play in the 5th. First pitch, righty swings and misses at a breaking ball. And the count's 0-1. Rodriguez really reaching for that pitch on the outer half. One strike pitch, swung on, fouled off behind home plate, right into sweet level. And the count's quickly 0-2. Rodriguez with a batting glove on just his left hand. It's a black batting glove. Bare right hand on top of it as he grips a black bat. 2-strike pitch. Swung on, fought off, foul and out of play on the right side. Count remains 0-2. Rodriguez, a member of Luis Soho's coaching staff for the Venezuelan team at the World Baseball Classic this past winter. Ground ball, foul of first base. Rodriguez stays alive at 0-2. 4-0 Long Island. Two outs, top of the seventh inning. 0-2 count to Luis Rodriguez, the catcher for Bridgeport. Snell sets and deals. Swung on. Hit high in the air. In right towards the line. Bailey right there. And he makes a two-hand catch. Jogs towards the seats and throws it. Fakes the throw. Hands it to a fan right down the right field line. Ian Snell with a 1-2-3 seventh inning for the Ducks. Heading to the bottom half of the seventh. It's time to get up and stretch. The Ducks looking to stretch a 4-0 lead here on the home of Long Island Ducks baseball, 103.9 RCN.
Your attention, please, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Now, for the people of Bridgeport Patriots, number 20, Alex Hinshaw, number 20. Don't forget, fans, at the end of the city, we will have a winning 50-50 raffle ticket number for you. That's at the end of the seventh inning.
4-0 Long Island ahead of Bridgeport as the bottom of the seventh begins. Alex Hinshaw, the lefty, relieving Mike Parisi. The Bridgeport starter went 6 innings, gave up 7 hits, 4 runs, just 2 of them earned, with 2 walks and 3 strikeouts. He threw 111 pitches, 67 of them for strikes. 3-4-5 in the Ducks order due up here. Bryant Nelson, Bill Hall, and Adam Bailey. Nelson 1-for-3, singled and scored in the 3-run first inning. Now he'll bat from the right side against the lefty Hinshaw. From the stretch, the first pitch. That is low for ball one. Hinshaw making just his fifth appearance on the season. In 4 innings, he has given up 4 runs, all earned on just 1 hit. 7 walks and 7 strikeouts. 7 walks in 4 innings, not the numbers that you want to see. The kick and the 1-0. That's into the knees to even the count. Hinshaw pitched in 2 games for Somerset this season, also played for the Toronto Blue Jays AAA affiliate, the Buffalo Bisons. He had 17 walks and 11 innings there. 1-1. That misses inside, bouncing towards the feet of Nelson. And I think it kicked up and caught Alan Reyes, the umpire. And he is in some pain. He has tossed the mask away. And he is bent over just behind home plate. All the umpires coming towards him along with Dottie Pitchford, the trainer for the Ducks. There, huddling around Alan Reyes. That might have caught him in the face or perhaps on the arm. 4-0 Long Island over Bridgeport. Bottom of the seventh inning. Nobody out. 2-1 count to Brian Nelson. Alex Hinshaw playing parts of three different seasons in the majors, most recently last season. Threw in 2 games with the Cubs and 31 games with the Padres. He came up through the Giants system. He played in the majors with the Giants in 2008 and 2009. He was drafted 4 times overall, finally signing in 2005 out of San Diego State. Looks like Reyes is back, ready to go. Nelson tapping home plate with a black bat. Hinshaw ready. The kick and the 2-1. Swung on, reaching and poking foul on the right side for Nelson. Now the count's 2-2. Hinshaw drafted out of high school in the 28th round in the year 2000 out of Claremont High School in Claremont, California. The Giants took him then. They took him again in the 29th round of 2002 out of Chaffee College in Rancho Cucamonga. Didn't sign then either. 2-2 pitch. Swung on, hit on the ground, up the middle, and through for a base hit. Bryant Nelson sneaking a single up the middle, his second hit of the ball game. Ducks have the leadoff man on here in the bottom of the seventh. Long Island already with a 4-0 lead. Here's Bill Hall. He had a fly ball to left field his first time up that bounced out of the glove of Austin Crum, ruled a hit. Hall eventually came around to score in that 3-run frame. He has struck out twice since then. Mike Parisi had only 3 strikeouts, and 2 of them were Bill Hall. Another lefty-righty matchup. A set at the neck, look at first, and the pitch. Fastball well outside, count 1-0. So after his first JUCO year, Alex Hinshaw drafted again out of Chaffee College, this time in 2003. It was the Marlins picking him in the 25th round, but he didn't sign again. Went to San Diego State and then was drafted in 2005 by the Giants. Look at first, 1-ball pitch. Hall takes it just inside, and the count moves to 2-0. Probably the most famous player, at least in recent times, out of San Diego State University would be Steven Strasburg, the pitcher for the Washington Nationals, the number 1 overall pick in 2009. Hall ready for the 2-0. A look at first. Hinshaw fires. Misses outside with another fastball. And the count's 3-0. Tony Gwynn went to San Diego State. He's now the head coach there. Greg Nettles and Mark Grace, along with Buddy Black. So a solid core of major leaguers playing their college ball at San Diego State. Hinshaw ready, and the 3-ball pitch. Swung on, fisted foul towards the right side, bouncing off the dasher boards in front of the camera well. Hall with the green light, and he spoils the 3-0 pitch. Tony Gwynn, of course, the father-in-law of a former Duck, Kennard Jones, marrying Tony Gwynn's daughter. Kennard Jones owns his own apparel company, and they will be supplying the All-Star Game uniforms this year for the All-Star Game this Wednesday down in Southern Maryland. Nelson leads off first, the 3-1. Fastball low for ball 4. Bill Hall draws the walk. Third issue today by Bluefish Pitching. Another Municipal Credit Union walk with a purpose. Every time a Ducks batter walks, the Quackerjack Foundation wins. Nelson up to second base and Hall walking up to first. Nobody out, two on for the Ducks, and a 4-0 lead in the bottom of the seventh inning. Here's Adam Bailey, the right fielder, the only left-handed bat in the lineup. Three switch hitters, but Bailey, the only left-handed bat. And in fact, he is the only left-handed bat, field player-wise, on the roster. Both Danny Perales and Ben Broussard being signed in recent weeks. So it's just Bailey now swinging from the left side. Ben Broussard played his first game for the Omaha Storm Chasers yesterday, went 1-for-3 with a walk. Lefty-lefty matchup here. Check of second base. Long look, the first pitch. Bailey takes a fastball for a strike on the inside corner. Ben Broussard played first base and batted fifth. Storm Chasers were down in Round Rock. From the stretch, the set, a look at second, and the one-strike pitch on the way. Bailey swings, grounds it weakly to the right side. Second baseman Mayora sliding left, throws to first to the pitcher Hinshaw covering. Both runners advance. So it wasn't a sacrifice bunt, but it has the same effect as Bailey scoots Nelson to third and Hall to second. Grounds out 4-3 for the first out of the bottom of the seventh inning. Ducks with a 4-0 lead, and Ray Navarette stepping up. He drove in a run in the first inning with his sacrifice fly. Since then, 0-for-2, a ground out and a fly out. Navarette open stance from the right side. Infield playing at halfway, shifted towards the left. First pitch. Strike on the inside corner. Alex Hinshaw, the pitcher, 6'2", 175 pounds, from Newburgh, Oregon. Stands very straight. Very direct posture. Fans oohing and eyeing at fireworks fired off well beyond the right center field wall. One strike pitch. Swung on, hit high and deep down the left field line. Curling, it's fair, and no, it's foul. If it was fair, it was gone. Navarette carried his bat all the way up the first base line. As he really stroked that one, but it just curled foul, and he's now in an 0-2 hole. Navarette making a bid for his third homer of the season. But it just hooked foul. Took Ray a long time to get started here in 2013, and his first home run on May 3rd. Infield still at halfway. Hinshaw holds the ball behind his back and steps off. 4-0 Ducks. One away, bottom of the seventh inning, two in scoring position. As Louis Rodriguez, the catcher, jogs out to talk to Alex Hinshaw, the pitcher. Take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard. One game already in the books. Somerset beat Camden 6-2 this afternoon. That game played as part of the first half schedule. So it goes down in the first half. Does not change any order in the standings, but was played for league purposes in the first half of the season. Everybody set. And the 0-2. Swing and a miss. Navarette waving at a slider on the outer half. And he is set down. Swinging, fourth strikeout of the day overall for Bluefish pitching as Ralph Enriquez steps in.
Ducks catcher, number 30.
York with a 4-0 lead over Lancaster, that game in the top of the eighth. Camden with a 7-0 lead over Somerset in game two of their day in the bottom of the sixth. And Sugarland with a 9-0 lead over Southern Maryland in the bottom of the seventh. Four shutouts being pitched right now in the Atlantic League. 4-0 Ducks here. Two down, Ralph Enrique is in. Takes first pitch inside for ball one. Switch hitter Enriquez batting from the right side against the lefty Hinshaw. Enriquez 2-for-3 in the ballgame, two singles, sandwiching a ground out to first. Enriquez cuffs the pants high, showing off black socks. One ball pitch. Swung on and missed, waving at a changeup. And the count evens to 1-1. Infield back, outfield straight away. Bryant Nelson leads off third. Bill Hall off second for the Ducks. Kick in the 1-1. Fastball misses low. It's 2-1. Hinshaw might have overthrown that a little bit. He twisted off the mound towards the third base side. Enriquez out of Key West, Florida. Most recently played in the Mariners organization. 2-1 pitch. And is outside. The count's 3-1. Enriquez, born in 1987. Hinshaw on the mound, 1982. But they were both drafted, or signed, out of the draft in 2005. Enriquez went in the second round. Hinshaw, the 15th. 3-1 count. The fans responding to the scoreboard plea for noise. And the 3-1 pitch. Swung on, fisted foul. Up to the sweet deck and bat right back down into the seats. A mad scramble for that foul ball. And finally the man in the light green t-shirt and the blue shorts picks it up. High fives with his companion wearing a St. Louis Cardinals hat. It's a full count to Ralph Enriquez. Two down, bottom of the seventh inning. Ducks with a 4-0 lead. A set. Payoff pitch. Called strike three on the outside corner. Enriquez can't believe it. Fans booing at home plate umpire Alan Reyes says.
Here's a word from Cancer Treatment Centers.
Enriquez marches back to the dugout. Second strikeout in the inning for Hinshaw and the Ducks with no runs on one hit, no errors, two left in scoring position for Long Island. Through seven full, the Ducks with a 4-0 lead over Bridgeport here on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN.
Call it as a cancercenter.com. Appointments available now. Automotive Group. Our guest promo crew is going to be tossing t-shirts into the lower levels of the stand. So, if you want a t-shirt, we need to hear you. Make some noise. And fans, if you purchase a 50-50 raffle ticket, here is tonight's winning number. Anthony has also put it up on the scoreboard for you. Listen carefully, it's a tricky number. Tonight's winning number is 911119. That's 911119. If you have the winning 50-50 raffle ticket, please take it to the table in front of the Wild Wing Shop to claim your prize. Once again, that winning 50-50 raffle ticket number is 911119. 911119. Congratulations from the Long Island Ducks and the Quacker Jack Foundation.
Top of the eighth inning at Bethpage Ballpark, I'm Tom Felice, and the Long Island Ducks have a 4-0 lead over the Bridgeport Bluefish. On a hot night like this, chill out with a cold cup of Hampton Coffee Company Gourmet Ice Coffee, available right now at the Bethpage Ballpark concession stands. Hampton Coffee is the preferred coffee of the Long Island Ducks. Visit HamptonCoffeeCompany.com or head out to their cafes in the Hamptons. Jared Lansford in for the eighth inning, just like yesterday when the setup man struck out two in a perfect eighth inning. Lansford on the season having a very good year. He has been named an all-star. He's 2-1 with a 2.37 earned run average in 31 games. He has thrown 30 and a third innings, giving up 22 hits, 9 runs, 8 of those earned, 31 strikeouts versus 9 walks. It'll be 8-9-1, Victor Diaz, Iggy Suarez, and Daniel Mayora here for the Bluefish. In the top of the 8th, the Ducks ahead 4-0. Long Island with the win yesterday to improve to 3-1 in the second half of the season, just like the Bluefish. A righty-righty matchup starts this inning off, and the first pitch to Diaz. Fastball, fisted foul, and out of play right side. Ending up in the second set of seats. He's behind 0-1. Diaz struck out swinging his first time. Walked in the fifth inning. The only walk issued so far by Ducks pitching. Lansford, the fourth pitcher for Long Island. One strike pitch. Fastball swung on and missed. The count's quickly 0-2. Starter Dontrell Willis went 5 innings, gave up 4 hits and the 1 walk. He had 3 strikeouts as well. Eric Threets threw a scoreless 6th inning. Ian Snell a perfect 7th. 2-strike pitch. Fastball high. And we count now 1-2 to Victor Diaz. Now 0 for his last 12 with his strikeout earlier. Lansford sets. The kick and the 1-2. Fastball misses low and away, and the count evens up. Looked like Lansford might have overthrown that pitch just a little bit, falling off the rubber on the first base side, which will happen to a right-handed pitcher from time to time. Diaz ready. The 2-2. Swung on, skied to center. Binnick looked at it, backs up, and makes the catch for the first out of the top of the 8th. Ducks with a 4-0 lead. Bridgeport yet to have a man advance past second base, and that happened just once. Luis Rodriguez in the 3rd inning. He singled, moved to second on Daniel Mayora's 2-out single, but they were both stranded in the 3rd inning as the Ducks have given up 5 hits and just 1 walk through 7 1/3 innings so far. Here's the 9-hitter, Iggy Suarez. Shortstop 0-2. Popped out to his shortstop counterpart, Dan Lyons, and struck out looking. First pitch. Swung on, hit on the ground, too short. Off the glove of Lyons as he moved right and in to left center field. Big turnaround first base for Suarez. But Lyons picks it up and throws it back in. Wait for the scoring on that one. That could go either way. Lyons with a long way to range left, and it kicked off his glove.
Second baseman, number 22, Daniel Mayora.
Either way, Suarez on first base with one away, and it's an error on Dan Lyons, 12th of the season, and errors in back-to-back games for the shortstop. Here's a leadoff man, Daniel Mayora, 1-for-3, a single sandwiched by 2 groundouts. First pitch. Fastball high for ball 1. Suarez taking a big lead off of first base. 4-0 Ducks. One on, man on first for the Bluefish here in the top of the eighth inning. Lansford from the stretch, sets the belt, and fires. Fastball low. And now it's a 2-0 count. Iggy Suarez played for the Sugar Land Skeeters last season. 6 home runs and 20 doubles in 106 games. Right-handed batter with a slightly open stance. And the pitch to Mayorez swung on, hit into right. Bailey with a step in and two back to make the catch for the second out of the inning.
Left fielder, number 15, Austin Crum.
Here's Austin Crum, the left fielder. Singled his last time up. It was a bloop pop towards the third base line. Eric Threets, the pitcher, was the closest. He dove but could not make the play. As Crum had an infield single that went some 60 feet from home plate, probably about 40 feet in the air. Left-handed bat, Austin Crum. Lansford a righty on the hill. Suarez leads off first, the pitch. Swung on, hit towards the right side. Long way for Barfield, sliding on the grass, throw to first, too late. Crum beating out that infield single. A nice play by Barfield just to get to the ball. Crum it on with the
right
infield hit. Suarez up to second base. Two on with two out in the top of the eighth. Ducks ahead 4-0. But the Bluefish certainly threatening with Prentice Redmond stepping to the plate. Redmond 0-3. Ground out to first. Fly out to right. Fly out to left. Jared Lopez looking to set him down and end the inning. First pitch, breaking ball high for ball one. Prentice Redmond's brother, Tyke, played in the majors, also played for the Bridgeport Bluefish. Redmond ready, right-handed. A look at second, the one ball pitch. Fastball on the outside corner, evens the count. Both Prentice and Tyke played at Tuscaloosa Academy High School down in Alabama. The only other two players with minor league baseball experience out of Tuscaloosa Academy, also brothers, 1-1. Swung on and missed. Big curve from Lansford. And the count goes to 1-2. Mark and Michael Obradovich, a set of brothers, along with the Redmond brothers, out of Tuscaloosa Academy High School. Lansford off the mound on the first base side. Now he climbs back up the hill. 1-2 count to Redmond. Two on, two out. Top of the eighth, Ducks ahead 4-0. A look at second. Another look. And the 1-2 home. Breaking ball in the dirt. Count evens to 2-2. Redmond, an all-star last season with Bridgeport, will not be attending the all-star game this season. Austin Crum, the man on first base, will be. Iggy Suarez, the runner off second, will not. The pitcher, Jared Lansford, will be for the Ducks. 2-2. Fastball missing outside. Now a full count to Prentice Redmond. Ralph Enriquez, the catcher, steps in front of home plate, signaling something to the fielders. Ducks up 4-0, but the tying run in the on-deck circle. Big pitch here from Jared Lansford. Full count, two away, top of the eighth. From the stretch, the kick, the pitch. That is low for ball four. Lansford walks Redmond and loads the bases.
Designated hitter number two, Alexis Gomez, number two.
Here's Alexis Gomez, and he represents the tying run. The Ducks with a 4-0 lead. Two outs, top of the eighth, but the bases loaded for the Bluefish. 10th walk of the season for Jared Lansford. He's now thrown 31 innings. Just the second walk today and in this entire series by the Ducks pitching staff. No walks in the 3-2 win yesterday. Gomez in from the left side, 1-3. Takes the first pitch strike at the knees. Gomez singled in the second inning, was picked off, has two flyouts after that. Swing and a slicing fly ball to left. Lyons dies, he can't get it, and it's down for a hit. Suarez scores. Krum comes in two. Two-run score on a two-run double for Alexis Gomez, and all of a sudden, it's a 4-2 ball game. A looping fly down the left field line, fell in between the left fielder Hall, Lyons the shortstop, and Nelson the third baseman, and it goes down as a two RBI double for Alexis Gomez. Now the tying run stands on second base for the Bluefish. 4-2 Long Island with those two runs scoring on the double. Redmond ends up on third as Crum and Suarez score. Here's Luis Lopez, the third baseman. He's 0-3. Another right-handed bat. And the pitch. Swung on, hit high in the air down the right field line. Brodin, the first baseman, chasing, and then he watches as that ball flies into the seats. Count is 0-1. Inning started with a flyout by Victor Diaz, and Iggy Suarez reached on an error by shortstop Dan Lyons. Daniel Mayora flied out to right for the second out of the inning. Austin Crum with a hit. Prentice Redmond with the walk. Alexis Gomez with a two-run double. Put the Bluefish on the board. 4-2 Long Island, two down top of the eighth. 0-1 pitch to Lopez. Fastball just misses inside. And the count evens to 1-1. All the runs in this inning will be unearned after the error by Lyons, the shortstop. Redmond off third, Gomez off second, 1-1. Strike on the inside corner. And the count is 1-2. Lansford with a chance to get out of the inning right here against Luis Lopez. Fans responding to the scoreboard call to get loud. Lansford bends the waist as he reads the sign from the catcher Enriquez. The set at the letters. And the 1-2. Swung on, hit on the ground up the middle. Lyons, shortstop, to his left, throws on to first. Brodin holds the bag, and they record the out. Bridgeport with two runs on two hits, one error, one walk, but two left in scoring position in the top of the eighth, heading to the bottom half of the frame. Long Island with a 4-2 lead over Bridgeport here on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN.
What's it gonna be? One. It is going to be one, Tommy Leachy. It is not number three, as it changed on hockey. And it is number one, Tommy Leachy. Congratulations, keep your take on that prize, courtesy of the Port Jeff Ferry.
Jared Lansford working out of trouble in the top of the eighth. As the bottom of the eighth begins, the Ducks hold a 4-2 lead after Bridgeport scored two unearned runs in the top of the eighth inning. And it'll be up to Craig Binnick, Dan Lyons, and Joe Ashbrodeen to try to put the Ducks back on the scoreboard and stretch the lead once again. The 2013 LI Ducks Youth Camps and Clinics have been announced, and registration is underway. The first clinic coming up pretty soon, July 19th and July 20th. A two-day camp followed by one in August, August 16th and August 17th. Camp runs from 9 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. both days, and for more information, give a call to 631-940-3825, extension 102, or go online to liducks.com and look at the info there. First pitch, Binnick takes it inside for ball one. It's Jeff Fulcino on the mound. He's the closer for the Bluefish, looking like Willie Upshaw just wants to get him some work. Righty-righty matchup, Fulcino to Binnick. And the one-ball pitch. That's into the knees on the inside corner. Count to 1-1. Binnick walked in the first inning. Drove in a run with a single to center in the third. Reached on a fielder's choice in the sixth. Swings and misses at that pitch. And the count's now 1-2. Fulcino has not pitched since June 29th, so it's been a week. The 1-2. Breaking ball low, bounces off the catcher Rodriguez all the way to the backstop. And the count now 2-2 to Binnick. Bridgeport with a couple of blowouts as of late, so there's been no need for the closer. And now Fulcino in to get some work here against the Ducks. 2-2. Binnick swings and misses. Just caught a piece of it, actually. And Rodriguez, the catcher, can't hold on. Fulcino on the season. 1-0 record, .90 ERA. 7 saves in 19 ball games. He's thrown 20 innings with 23 strikeouts, just 5 walks. 2-2. Swung on. Bounced on 2 hops to short. Suarez on the backhand. Throws to first. And that retires Binnick for the first out of the bottom of the eighth inning. The Ducks holding a 4-2 lead. Fulcino, named the All-Star team. Kevin Baez coaching third base for the Ducks, seeing what he'll have to work with as the manager of the Liberty Division squad in the All-Star game coming up this Wednesday. Here's Dan Lyons, the shortstop. He was an All-Star last season. Swings the first pitch. Hits it on one hop to third. Lopez fields and fires across the diamond to retire Lyons. That is the second out of the inning. Ducks with a 4-2 lead here in the bottom of the eighth. Top of the order, Joe Ashbrodeen stepping up. He's been cooled tonight. 0-for-3 with a walk. Average dropping to .327. Came into the game third in the league in hitting at .331. Switch hitter bats on the left side against the righty Fulcino. Fulcino rubbing his face with his bare right hand. Now it looks like everybody ready to go. First pitch. That is a strike at the knees. Count 0-1. Brodeen heading to the All-Star game. He'll be teammates with Fulcino. One strike pitch. Swung on. Line to left center field. Falling fast, and it's down for a hit in front of James Simmons. Joe Ashbrodeen now with a hit in 17 of his past 20 games as he knocks that single to center. Sends up Josh Barfield, the second baseman. He now has hits in 9 of his last 11 after his double in the second inning. He reached on a fielder's choice and scored in the 3-run first. Barfield reached on a fielder's choice. Bryant Nelson and Bill Hall followed with singles. Adam Bailey reached on an error. Ray Navarette with a sacrifice fly. And Ralph Enriquez, an RBI single for those three runs. In the first inning, Ducks tacked on another run in the third. They now lead 4-2, bottom of the eighth, two outs. Brodin on first. Set, first pitch. Check swing. That pitch was inside, and Barfield held up. It's a 1-0 count. Barfield bats from the right side. Slightly open stance. Barfield wearing orange and black cleats. Long set, throw to first. Brodin backhand standing up. Brodin does lead the team in stolen bases, but this probably not a time to steal. These teams will be right back at it after the All-Star break. Three games in Bridgeport next Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. One ball pitch. Swung on. Skied behind second base. Mayor, the second baseman, gives way to the shortstop Suarez, who makes the play backpedaling on the outfield grass to retire Barfield and the Ducks in the top and the bottom of the eighth. No runs on one hit, no errors, one left on four Long Island. Heading to the ninth, time for the closer, Leo Rosales, to come out of the pen, looking to shut down the Bluefish and clinch a win for the Ducks. Long Island with a 4-2 lead, heading to the ninth here on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN.
Fans, I think Debbie's going to need some help. Is it 1, 2, or 3? What's going to be? 2 it is. Time number 1, we're off to a good start so far. And you got it, it's number 2, 30 SPF. Congratulations, Debbie. You're taking on that prize. Can this be a better love and health? Everyone help. What care feels like.
Leo Rosales in to close things out for the Ducks. Top of the ninth inning, Long Island with a 4-2 lead over Bridgeport. Rosales picked up the save last night as he struck out the side, but it was not without some drama. He gave up a hit and then a stolen base to Alexis Gomez, so the tying run was on second base, but Rosales struck out Luis Lopez to end the ball game. For Rosales, he is an Atlantic League All-Star, and on the season, he has a 2.03 ERA, 2-2 record, 14 saves, 27 games overall. In 26 and two-thirds innings, he's given up 28 hits, 8 runs, 6 of them earned, 31 strikeouts versus 13 walks, opponents hitting .262 against Rosales, 6 foot, 205, native of Los Angeles, California, turned 32 years old on May 28th. Rosales, a right-handed pitcher, will face James Simmons, Luis Rodriguez, and Victor Diaz, all right-handed hitters for the Bluefish here in the top of the ninth. Ducks looking to win this series, take two straight series to start the second half of the season. The Ducks win this game, they will be in first place by themselves in the Liberty Division, just 5 games into the second half of 2013. First pitch, Simmons swings and misses at a fastball behind 0-1. Simmons struck out swinging in the second, singled to center in the fifth, flied out to left in the seventh. Rosales lets the right arm hang as he reads the sign from the catcher, Ralph Enriquez. A set, one strike deal. Swing and a miss, another fastball. This one on the outside corner. Rosales ahead 0-2. Started off with 2 strikeouts yesterday before the Gomez single. 4-2 Ducks, top of the ninth. Leo Rosales trying to shut the door on the Bluefish. The pitch swung on, fouled in the netting behind home plate. Count remains 0-2. Simmons now has 100 at-bats with the Bluefish. He has struck out 47 times. Rosales looking to make it 48 in 101. The set at the letters. Two-strike offering. Breaking ball misses low. And now a 1-2 count. Rosales kind of peels his hat off after almost every single pitch. Ready to go again, 1-2. Swung on, hit on the ground. Two hops to second base. Barfield Field throws the first and retires the diving Simmons. He slid head first into the bag but was ruled out.
Catcher, number nine,
a lot of baseball people do not believe that diving head first is a prudent move, and it didn't work for Simmons there. The writer Jonah Carey will joke on Twitter that there should be a lava pit at first base for anyone who dives head first that way. Ducks up 4-2, one out in the top of the ninth. Here's Luis Rodriguez, the catcher, 1-for-3 in the ball game. First pitch fastball high off the glove of Enriquez all the way to the backstop. And the count's 1-0. Rodriguez singled in the third, grounded into a 6-4-3 double play in the fifth, flied out to right in the seventh inning. One ball pitch, that misses outside. And the count to 2-0. Bryant Nelson guarding the line down at third. Outfield straight away. Two ball pitch. Swung on line. Pass Nelson at third base and into left field for a hit. Rodriguez sprinting around first base, but Bill Hall with a strong throw back into the infield, holding Rodriguez to a single. Eighth hit of the ball game for the Bluefish. And there's a man on with a man out. Top of the ninth, and the tying run coming to the plate in the form of Victor Diaz. Diaz has averaged down to 188 with his 0-for-2 performance today. A strikeout, a walk, and a fly out to center. Another right-handed batter against the righty Rosales. First pitch. Swung on, fouled off. Right side out of play. Counts 0-1. Rosales receives a new baseball, circles around the mound, ends up at the back, rosins up that right hand, still bouncing the rosin bag. And now he's back on the rubber, ready to go. Short lead off first for Rodriguez. Not a stolen base threat. 0-1. As a called strike on the inside corner. Rosales ahead. 0-2. Gels bends at the waist, now sets at the letters. Enriquez sets up outside. 0-2. Swung on, hit on. Two hops to short. Lyons flips to Barfield for one at second. On to first, Brodin. Tags the runner going by, double play, and the ball game is over. Ducks win. A bit of a nifty double play to end it, but the Ducks take this game by a 4-2 count and take the first two games of the series against the Bridgeport Bluefish. The final score of this one, Long Island 4, Bridgeport 2. The post-game show coming your way next here on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN.
Tomorrow's game, all games on the 2013 Long Island Ducks schedule are available right now as you leave the ballpark at the Long Island Ducks ticket office, which is
is open for your convenience right now. The ticket office is located to the west gate of our ballpark. Or you can go to LIDucks.com. We look forward to seeing you tomorrow evening. In just a few moments, we'll get tonight's Pleasures post-game pitch contest underway. Your chance to win a valuable prize for Pleasures is coming up. But first, let's turn things over to the Long Island Ducks on-field host right there by home plate and right there by the grill from Pleasures. Here's Jason Lynn.
Thank you, Bulldog Tom. Fans, let's hear one more time for your Long Island Ducks. Now, before we get to our Pleasures post-game pitch, this Trouting Weather Report is brought to you by News 12 Trouting Weather, Cablevision, Channel 61. Our weather right now here at Bethpage Ballpark, it is 79 degrees, humid and cloudy. If you're heading home using public transportation, the Long Island Railroad, there is no service on the West Hempstead Line for the weekend. But if you're heading home by car, there are no major delays to report. Now let's take a look up there right now on the Duck Vision scoreboard for this word from News 12.
The Long Island Ducks with a 4-2 win over the Bridgeport Bluefish. The Ducks have now won three straight ball games, and they move to 4-1 in the second half of the season. The Ducks got things started early with three runs in the first. Joe Ashbordine walked to lead it off. He was eliminated on a fielder's choice that allowed Josh Barfield to reach base. Bryant Nelson singled, so did Bill Hall to load the bases, and Adam Bailey hit an innocent ground ball to first. Victor Diaz couldn't field it. The ball went right between his legs off his right foot, kicking into foul territory, and that allowed Barfield to score the first run of the ball game. Ray Navarette followed with a sacrifice fly to score Nelson, and then Ralph Enriquez with an RBI single to second base, scoring Bill Hall. The Ducks with those three runs in the first. They added another one in the third. Adam Bailey led off with a double. Moved to third base on Ralph Enriquez's ground out. And then Craig Binnick had a single up the middle to score Bailey and make it 4-2. Things got interesting in the eighth inning. Jared Lansford was in the ball game. Started the inning with a fly out by Victor Diaz to center. Then Iggy Suarez reached on an error by Dan Lyons at shortstop. Daniel Mayora flied out to right field for the second out, but Austin Crum singled in the second base hole. Prentice Redmond walked, and Alexis Gomez hit a two-run double to left, just sneaking the ball in between the shortstop, third baseman, and left fielder. As the Bridgeport Bluefish were on the board, but Louis Lopez grounded out to end the threat with a tying run on second base. And then Leo Rosales got out of the ninth inning with a 6-4-3 double play to wrap things up and give the Ducks the victory. Time for the Nico Lock Player of the Game. And this will be a joint award for the Ducks pitching staff. In nine innings, they had just two walks and no earned runs allowed. The two runs Jared Lansford gave up in the eighth were both unearned runs. And so the whole Ducks pitching staff wins Nico Lock Players of the Game honors in this one. Nico Lock, retaining walls and paving stones, a company synonymous with quality and service in the manufactured concrete industry for almost 50 years. Step aside one more time when we come back. A look around the Atlantic League and get you set up for everything going on tomorrow in the series finale between the Bluefish and the Ducks. You're listening to Long Island Ducks Baseball on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN. The Long Island Ducks with a 4-2 victory over the Bridgeport Bluefish here at Bethpage Ballpark tonight. Long Island winning three straight ball games, and they have taken the lead in the Liberty Division here in the second half of the season. Long Island improving to 4-1 so far here in the second half. Other scores throughout the Atlantic League: York shutting out Lancaster. That was a 4-0 ball game in Pennsylvania. Camden with a 7-1 lead over Somerset. That game in the top of the eighth in Somerset. And Sugar Land ahead 11-0 on Southern Maryland. That game in the top of the ninth at Regency Furniture Stadium. In the big leagues, the Yankees won 5-4 over Baltimore. Milwaukee up 6-5 on the Mets in the top of the seventh. The Mets just pushed a run across in that one. Tomorrow, the series wraps up with a 5:05 first pitch. Gates open at 4:05. Pre-game autographs, as always, on Sundays, along with post-game Kids Run the Bases presented by Bethpage Federal Credit Union. It'll be James Hauser for the Ducks. He's 6-0 on the season with a 2.55 ERA. He will be countered by a lefty for the Bluefish, Miguel Martinez. He's 1-2 with a 3.95 ERA. So we hope, if you are able, that you find your way out to Bethpage Ballpark for that one tomorrow night as the Ducks go for the series sweep over the Bridgeport Bluefish here in Central Islip. That'll do it. I would like to thank Phil Francovella back at the 103.9 RCN Studios for all of his help getting this broadcast on the air and keeping it on the air. And that'll do it for myself, Tom Felice, until tomorrow when the North Shore LIJ Southside Hospital pregame show starts up at 4:50. I bid you good night and hope to hear from you soon. That'll do it as the Ducks win 4-2 over Bridgeport here on the home of the Ducks, 103.9 RCN.